The following is a live presentation of CBC Sports.
Will you listen to this? What a fabulous start. Canada on it. Scores! Canada keeps it in from the blue line. Sacking shot, scores! Go Sacking with that famous wrist shot.
Night one was Canada's. The second night requires a second win. Fast start, Slovakia.
Hello, Canada and hockey fans in the United States and different lands.
We'd love to teach the world to skate in perfect harmony. Live in Montreal this evening, Team Canada tries to earn home ice for the playoffs as they meet Slovakia. You can see why. We'll take a short break, come back to the madness inside here at the Bell Center.
World Cup of Hockey on CBC. Brought to you by Tim Hortons. Go Canada Go. By CIBC. CIBC. For what matters. And by Dodge and your Dodge retailers. Grab life by the horns.
Can inspiration change your mood? Can luxury feel intimate and stylish? Yes. Can it move like this, look like this, cost less than you'd expect, and still turn heads easily? The totally new Chrysler 300, starting at $29,995. Chrysler, inspiration comes standard.
Introducing a new way to make tea using a time-honored tradition. Loose tea leaves. The secret to great tasting tea is allowing the water to surround the tea leaves, coaxing out every last drop of flavor. So, Tim Hortons had a third generation tea master design the ideal tea steeper, which gently steeps the tea. For a perfect pot, every time. Tim Hortons new steep tea. Great tasting tea, every time.
Always fresh at Tim Hortons.
Another wild evening in Montreal, second game of the North American loop of the World Cup. Team Canada taken to the ice before a jam-packed Bell Center. Rostislav Stanek gets the nod in goal for Slovakia. He's a Washington Capitals prospect. What a challenge for him tonight. I'm with Kelly Rudy, Brian Burke on the ice. And Brian, Team Canada's approach to Slovaks this evening.
This is a great team on paper. Lots of skill. I think Canada has to bang them hard, bang them often, and stay out of the box.
Sweden got a little out of gas in the third period this afternoon against the Czechs. So can Canada come through with that kind of a physical game against Slovakia back-to-back nights?
I think so. They got two new players in the lineup. Cannon's going in, and also Chris Draper. I think they have the gas.
How about the Slovaks, Kelly?
Well, we know, Ron, they're a talented team, but I still don't think on paper they match up with Canada. I know it's boring, but if I were them, I'd just line up four or five guys on my own blue line and wait for turnovers and get opportunities that way.
They're the home team. They'll get the second anthem here. Oh, Canada, from the Bell crowd, and then off to Bob Cole and Harry.
Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the singing of the Canadian and Slovakian national anthems. D'abord, l'hymne national du Canada par Monsieur Charles Prévost-Linton.
Oh, Canada, terre de nos aïeux, ton front est saint de fleurs en glorieux, car
ton bras sait porter l'épée, il sait porter la croix. Ton histoire est une épopée des plus brillants exploits. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh Canada, we stand on guard for.
Et maintenant, l'hymne national de Slovaquie avec Monsieur John Chandick.
Na Tatro za blízka hromy divu biju, na Tatro za blízka hromy divu biju, zastavme ich bratia, veď sa oni stratia, Slováci ožijú. Zastavme ich, bratia, veď sa oni stratia, Slováci ožijú. To Slovensko naše potiaľ tvrdo spalo. To Slovensko naše potiaľ tvrdo spalo. Ale blesky hromu zbudujú ho tomu, aby sa prebralo. Ale blesky hromu zbudujú ho tomu, aby sa prebralo.
A sellout last night, and they promised another sellout tonight. Let's hope it's just as exciting as the opener. Good evening, everybody. Bob Cole with you again. Harry Neal alongside. Here are the goalies. Martin Brodeur was solid last night against Team USA, stopping 23 of 24 shots in Canada's 2-1 win. He has only lost once in his last six games, now with Team Canada. Rastislav Stana is a seventh-round pick of the Washington Capitals and helped lead Slovakia to a gold medal at the 2002 World Championships. Referees, this is Steve Walken. With him will be Don Van Massenhoven, Jean Marat here. Rastico on the lines. We're underway with Dimitra, Hossa, Nagy starting up front for Slovakia. Canada starting out with Lemieux, Sakic and Maginga. Number 66 cleared it. Max Niedermayer, 27, with Robin Regier, 28, on the blue line for Team Canada to start. Roger watching the puck come by him. Canada comes back to pick it up. Regier, solid hit over there, and Sakic poked it ahead. They get out as far as Big Chara, and that's where they're stopped. Richard Littner is his defense partner to start, but they're changing quickly. Niedermayer forced to throw it back, and this is a fast-skating team, the Slovakia squad. And they're young too. First game for them, so they should be fresh. At center ice, a loose puck. Wrapping out of us, Vishnovsky. Got it into the zone all right. Foot had to hurry that one. And a forecheck hard against Team Canada. And they're in there now. Long shot, tipped in front. Here's another chance. And it's flattened in front of the net. Gavarek and back four. Team Canada's Heatley was upended trying to go in. Vishnovsky caught him with a hip check. Brewer passed the puck back. Dumped down the ice. That is Vishnovsky, number 17. Flipped it around the goal. Pushed her back. Kick knocked into the side of the net, and Vyshnovsky will come out with it. Down to center ice, they bring it in. On the right side is Samek. Shaken up, but keeps going. Center back in front of him. That's stolen. Team Canada back out. Racing away is Richards. Drops it back. The pass just missed Gagne, and this is a quick start. Great pace to start this hockey game. Slovakia and Team Canada. Slapped along the boards. And on that, San Luis was nailed by two Slovaks. Pretty hard, too. Seems to be okay. He stays on. Looking for a pass. It's high for him, and he missed it. And it bounced out over the line. Cleared ahead by Bart Tetzko, and he's headed off now as the two teams are changing. Coming up to 3 minutes, no whistle yet. This is great. Sacking a stop in his tracks at the blue line. So Canada back to regroup. Fire, rink wide, that's intercepted. Good play, right away, that fires right on, and a big rebound. Cleared immediately. That is Ginla poking it behind the net for Redden. Back to the corner it goes. Team Canada watching the two forecheckers come in. So back in those navy blue jerseys, Canada tonight. In the white, black and red trim. Back in there for Slovaks in their own zone. That pass intercepted, shot, knocked down. And away comes Hossa after being knocked down again. Score! Whoa, baby! What a pace! And what a shot down low by Fort. Oh, yeah. 1-0.
Well, Chara lost the puck. Joe Thornton circled out the sideboards and beat goaltender Stana with a low shot, and Canada just inside 4 minutes scores the first goal of the game. It's intercepted right there, and that's where the problem starts. There's the pickpocket by Thornton on Chara, and into the net, Joe Thornton scores his first of the tournament.
Look at that shot, would you? A dandy. 3-0-2, it's 1-0, Team Canada. Canada on the attack again, right after scoring, they're looking for another. Doan left it on the boards. It's batted away by a glove, it's okay. Touched by Team Canada, Doan played it back. Here's another chance right in front of Thornton. This time he's tied up. Thornton again, strong, he handles the puck, long shot, doesn't work. Here's Thornton, look out! Fires in the pass, and it was tipped away by Vyshnovsky just in time. Kvitra takes over in his own zone and coming away. He's a great skater. Stick handling well to center. Gets up to the line, dishes off to the left side, and out comes Brodeur. He saw two of them coming in, so he made that good move. Team Canada clearing it to center ice. Up there again for Team Canada's Draper. His first game. Draper centers it. It's knocked down. Here's a chance. Rolling away to center ice is Nagy. Up over the line and grabbing it. The shot by Dimitra. Hard and wide. Centered again. And Team Canada have a trio going to center. Down on this near side is Smith. He drops it back. Brewer fires it. Try to get it back to him. There it is to Smith. Around the net. Hit the side of the goal. There's a Cavalier making fancy moves. It won't get out. Foot will stop it. Shot it in. Smith again. Out front, Heatley. And the Cavalier. Cavalier again. Nice pass back to the point. The foot into Smith. All Canada here, folks. Smith out front. Scores! Wow! 2-0.
Ryan Smith circled out of the corner and was allowed to come right out in front of the net and put it in to make it 2-0 Canada. Inside 5 minutes. Here's how it all started. Adam Foot keeps it in. Smith gets it behind. Can't find somebody to pass it to. Walks out in front. And Suki made a bad play chasing him. He should have stayed in front till more of his teammates got back. And Canada goes ahead 2-0 early in the first period.
Two goals in a minute and 41 seconds. That's a dandy play by Ryan Smith. I guess he would smile. Well, what a start for Team Canada. Just like last night, they came out a blazing. And tonight, I think even a quicker start.
Well, Big Chara upset, I'm sure, as most of his teammates are at the two quick goals. And he's going to get a penalty. I don't know whether a Canadian player is going to go with him. Chara, 6'9", the tallest player in the NHL. And in the Slovakian media guide, they've got him born March 17th, 18th, and 19th. Canada will go on the power play. Chara gets a roughing penalty.
It doesn't rain, it pours. Two goals in a minute 41 as you look at the penalty against Big Chara.
He gets mad at Gagne and cross-checks him, then punches him. The referees decide he was the aggressor, so he gets the two.
Canada had two power play goals last night in five chances against the U.S. of A. Chara in for roughing. That'll float back inside the Canada blue line. Scoring play was Smith. Haven't got any assists on it yet. 4:43, the time of the goal. 2-0. Lemieux. Tap the pass ahead. Gets it again. Poked it up to Akima. Around the net. Team Canada. Cavalier and McGinley with Lemieux. Lemieux ready to set it up. There it goes. The shot is off the leg and wide. Beautiful pass by Mario that time. And it's knocked down the ice. Chara in the penalty box is their best defenseman. Canada's power play, first of the game. Onside at the line, cleared back out quickly, and Canada regrouping. Mario coming on, drops it back beautifully to Sakic. Sakic goes to the other side with it. Now they whip it around, the five of them. Sakic sees Lemieux, gives it to him. Lemieux sees Sakic, gives it to him again. The shot is tipped just wide of the net. Heatley is on it behind the net, and he falls. Sakic can't stop that. It's down the ice.
These two teams played to a 2-2 tie in the exhibition games in Ottawa. But certainly Canada starting quickly as they did last night against the Americans.
40 seconds left on this power play. Through center, Richards. Heatley with him, drops it back. Long pass, cross ice, now in front. That was flipped high by Danny Heatley. Boy, he got that away quickly. He's in front again. But the puck doesn't get to him this time. Richards was stopped behind the net, and Canada will regroup with 20 seconds left in the power play. Heatley back in. Got away from Suki and shot it around the net. Fired by Skrbak. Not out. Kept in by Team Canada. Another pass. Gets to San Luis. Back to the line. And out of foot. Here's San Luis. Oh, he had the open side. Mind you, it was a very sharp angle. But he missed it. Penalty is done. 2-0 Canada. Heatley in his own zone. Canada didn't get a shot on that power play, even though they control the puck very well. No shots on goal. Thornton and Smith, the goal scorers. Long pass through center. This pace continues by Team Canada especially. And Slovakia looks to be a little mesmerized with the speed shown by Canada. And they're forechecking hard now. That was a physical play. Good hit by Draper, who went in and dealt the blow. Here's Doan. Looked for the far side and missed it by just a few inches. Shot away down the ice by Nagy. They come in on goal. Lifted in on the net by Hossa. Big rebound is there. Robert with the initial stop. Up there, Nagy, number 27, and he falls along the boards inside that Canadian line. The puck there, they fight for it. It's slapped on the boards and down the ice. And that's going to be an icing call, I think, against Canada, yes. From the Bell Center in Montreal, this is World Cup Hockey on CBC.
Velocity meets versatility. The all-new Hemi-powered Dodge Magnum. Open it up from either end. Hit it!
Summer doesn't last forever, so enjoy it while you can. Get 15 pieces of original recipe seasoned chicken for only $16.99. But hurry, it's a limited time offer. There's more in the bucket.
Thank you. Passion of the Christ. Own it forever on DVD.
Tim Hortons supports over 50,000 kids across Canada who play Timbits hockey. It's a fun way for kids to learn the basics of the game. Timbits hockey. The first goal is having fun.
Like last night, Canada jumps into a 2-0 lead. Joe Thornton gets the first, and Ryan Smith walks out from behind the net to get the second.
McAvoy assisted on Smith's goal. Thornton, his goal unassisted. 302 and 443. That's Regier jumping on the loose puck right away. He's being checked though. Puck is to the line and out. Cavalier skating hard coming in. Look at the move now. Can he do it or what? He nearly went in that time. Just lost it. Now he's back up there again taking the pass. Flipped the high one in wide of the net. Smith. Heatley coming off the boards all the way with it, lost it. And Slovakia away with Gabarek firing the shot. Bad save. Big rebound kept in by Stuffle. Again, right in front. That time, Chetan tried to stick him away from the check shot. Puck in center and picked up by Smith again. With Sakic. Smith right in. Oh, what a chance for Aginla. Started last night too with a glorious chance in the first period. There's another one, but he comes up empty. We're nearing the halfway mark of the first period. Lemieux hit from behind, and that's going to be a penalty to Vishnevsky. Lemieux was shaken up.
Well, Vishnevsky came in, and he's going to get called for cross-checking. I don't think it was as much the hit from behind, because Lemieux was coming backwards along the boards. And in the opinion of the referee, it's a cross-checking call. And Lemieux was a little slow to get up. You wonder whether he got slightly hurt on that. Let's have a look at it here. Now there's Lemieux, you see, he's backing up. And it wasn't a violent check by any stretch, but he did cross-check him.
Well, it was a blind side for sure. Lemieux didn't see it coming. And the penalty has been called. 2-0, Canada leads, and now they got a power play again. Looking for the first shot, however, on goal with the man advantage. Vishnevsky cross-checking the call, 9-11 the time.
Mario Lemieux has played left wing before. In 91 and 92, when Pittsburgh won Stanley Cups, he spent a lot of time on a line with Yager and Francis. And in the 87 Canada Cup, he played on a line often with Wayne Gretzky at center. So playing the wing is not completely new to Mr. Lemieux.
Cavalier is there at center ice. Chara fires it hard. That won't get by Sakic, or yes, it does. Didn't quite control it, and then it just barely got out, and they have to come back onside. Chara has it in the zone. Poked it ahead. Mario took it from Lemieux behind the net, goes to the corner with that pass. It'll be down to the line. Sakic, they spread out now in this power play, looking to go up 3-0 early in this game. It is Mario taking the shot. He might get it now. There it is. And he ripped it on the short side and just missed. Sakic, nice play to keep it in. Fired a hard pass in there. On the boards. Chara roughing it up there, knocking his man down. Again, I got up and didn't like it and went back at him. At the line, Sakic. Very calmly passed it to Lemieux. He got it back on the other side again. Sakic is back waiting at the blue line. The pass gets in front. And Sakic just missed that, and it's down the ice. Here they go again, as Slovakia was changing, and Sakic hurried in as Brodeur made that nice lead pass from the goal mouth. Heatley lost it, slapped down the ice by a big Chara. He heads off. 30 seconds left on this power play. Vishnevsky in the box. 2-0, Canada. Nearing 11 minutes of play in the first. That's Danny Heatley. Richards there with him, but it's Slovakia bringing it out. Alenka flipped it up over the line after it is Forsberg. He had to kick it loose down in the corner. Can't get away from his check. Nita Meyer did a great job on him. And then Hedman, the puck out to center ice. He'll have to pick it up again in his own zone as he comes back. Nita Meyer takes it from the goalie, Brodeur. Once again. Manning the puck through center that time to Draper, and he tipped it in onside. Littner for Slovakia. And again, changing was Sharon. Back in there, Gagne fires it out the net. Got to the blue ice, and Stana jumped down on it with that big catching glove and held it. Mario's okay.
It's stop, shop, and drive clearance time at your Chrysler Jeep Dodge retailer. This is your chance to take advantage of 0% purchase financing on an incredible selection of our most popular models. They're all here, but with 0% purchase financing, they'll be moving fast. Hurry in and take your favorite new model for a test drive soon, because stop, shop, and drive clearance days end September 30th. Visit your neighborhood Chrysler Jeep Dodge retailer today.
All across the country, people are signing up for the new CIBC Unlimited Checking Account.
I signed up.
There you go, because they're tired of getting dinged with unexpected service charges.
No kidding.
Right, so now every transaction, withdrawal, bill.
Every debit, check.
All covered with one flat monthly fee.
But just online, right?
Everywhere. At the branch, at their bank machine.
On the phone.
At the store. It's all covered. It's a CIBC Unlimited Checking Account.
Hey, did you say unlimited checking?
Yeah, no, not that kind of checking.
Introducing the new CIBC Unlimited Checking Account. No limits, no surprises.
How to get 2 huge liters of Baskin-Robbins ice cream from our freezer to yours. First, make one of those periscopes so you can see where you're going. Walk slowly, breathe deeply. Upon arrival, clean out the freezer, bend at the knees, and clean and jerk each one into place. Next, get some police tape. Rope off the area in case of poachers. 2 liters of Baskin-Robbins ice cream, your choice of 10 flavors for a measly $10. Now get 2 free play-all-day passes to Ontario Place with your 2-for-10 purchase. Keep moving, kid. Nothing to see here.
Two coaches, Jan Filtz on the right, Pat Quinn on the left. Mr. Filtz coached the world tournament teams for Slovakia for the last 3 years and was the coach of the gold medal winner in 2002 at the World Championships.
Face off in the Slovakian zone. Kick loose by Draper. Thornton, they're watching him now. Slovakia getting out. That's easily broken up at the Canadian line. Thornton shot it in. Long way for Draper to go to pick it up. Scramble in the corner. Thornton again comes up at the blue line. Foot. Flipped the shot. Lister in front of the net was blocked. Doan tried to play it back. It got by Foot and down the ice, but good hustle by Eric Brewer to get back. 1-0. The score, 7:35 left in the first. Healy nearly stole one. It's kept onside by LeCavalier, but now shot out and down inside the Canadian line. Both teams continue to make these quick changes. Danny Heaton back to Smith and shot in for it. But it'll be Srbac. Gets it for Slovakia. Lost it. Heaton again. Bumped to the ice. Lost the puck. And it's cleared out by Stempel. Gaborik. Stop. Rebound. Stop. How about that for goaltending? Martin Brodeur looking solid. Yes, sir. He's the best. No doubt about it.
You don't want to let that Marian Gaborik get away on. He had 30 goals his first 2 years in Minnesota, only 18 last year, but he held out and missed training camp. And here's how the breakaway took place. This guy can shoot it, and he can skate, as you can see, and a bonus chance was stopped by Brodeur, who, for the first time in this game, had a couple of difficult saves to make.
He looked fabulous. 2-0. Canada. McGinley on the move in there, takes the hit, lost the puck. It's fired out by Slovakia, and coming away is Samik. Weak wide pass was good, but just ahead of the play, picking it up was Seaback. It's called.
Well, let's have a look at the 2 goals Canada scored early in the first period. Joe Thornton gets the first one for him in the tournament. He's played better every game, according to Pat Quinn. And here he will pickpocket Chara, walk in and slide it by Stana for the goal. And a little more than a minute later, Ryan Smith scores to make it 2-0.
Redden has the puck behind his own goal. Takes a long time to look around. He finds the opening to move it. Exactly. Took off and shot it in. Lemieux knew it and just flipped into the corner where Sackick just went by. His stick got caught in that divider back there with the two sheets. He got it back now and he's ready to go. Shot from the other side. He tried to tip it and just missed it. Lemieux checked his man. Lemieux gets the puck loose. And Seabach grabs it for Slovakia. In there is Samik from the corner and goes around the net. He's hammered by Lemieux. It's Mario up to. Mario in again. Another hit on Samik. Played back near the line and grabbed by Joe Sakic. Out he comes. Mario gets a hand as he skates off to the Canadian bench. Oh, my goodness. Somebody wondered if he'd play two in a row. Are you kidding? Are you kidding?
BC Children Learning. Envisions becoming reality. We see one patient, many experts, and developers discovering the next big thing. We see your potential. We're inspired to create software that helps you reach it.
Guitar, surfboard, ladder, and 12 2x4s.
Velocity meets versatility. The all-new Hemi-powered Dodge Magnum. Open it up from either end.
Hit it!
It doesn't come with a toy.
McDonald's new Chicken Selects. Seasoned white breast strips with a choice of three new dipping sauces for adults who've still got some kid in them.
I'm loving it.
McDonald's.
Just think how much better Slovakia'd be if they had Palfi, Bondra, Hanzus all injured, and Zednik's got food poisoning and can't play tonight. And of course, Zednik led the Montreal Canadiens last season in goals. And those are four pretty key guys to be playing without.
Under 6 minutes remaining in the period now. Canada with two early goals at 3:02, Thornton, and at 4:43, Smith. Orzak poked at it at the blue line. Chara, winds, faked, now shoots it. Radivojevic takes over, gets it back near the line. Chara's shot is up high and just wide of the net. Lodeur was having a tough time with the fullback player in the crease. The shot was away wide. Now it'll come to him, reached for it, but Adam Cook picked it off and shot it around the boards. They don't get it ahead very far, but now they will. They move it up across center ice to Richards. That shot by San Luis is stopped. Scanna got a stick on that. San Luis again gets it back. Gagne checked off the puck. Radivojevic brings it up the center and then flipped it in. He heads off here, changing again. Under 5 minutes left in the period. Canada moving up. Pace has settled a bit. Tremendous start to the hockey game. They're all close. Now Canada centers. Draper missed a great chance. Over his stick, and he got it again. Backhands it to the far side, the open ice. Up there is Doan. Picks it up, comes back. Centers it a little bit far for Draper. Side of the net. Draper after it again right there in that big circle, but it's shot off the boards and out to center ice. Hossen nearly got a break. He just missed it. It bounced over his stick. Now he has it and comes in for Slovakia. Putting in a goal. Little backhander from a sharp angle is stopped by Brodeur. 4:05 left in the period. Slovakia trying to pick it up. They'd love to get one here. 2-0 is the score, Canada. Nice play. Radivojevic back in front. The shot is blocked. Goes behind the net and centered by Chatin. But nothing worked again, and Smith cleared it. Cavalier just out of his reach. And nearly stole back just outside the line. pitches in for checking now. Canada swings away from him. That's Heatley. Nice move by Heatley to go to the far side and get going. Down is Smith, up over the line. Pounded in on the boards, but Heatley knew what to keep going. Heatley gets a hit behind the net. Cavalier digs it out, trying to get away from that check. He's all tied up from behind. Heatley won't reach that one, and Slovakia gets it down to center. We're looking better now as the period winds down with 3:12 left to play. Dumped off the boards and out and down the ice again inside the Slovak line. That is Vyshnovsky. Up he comes. Good move. And another. It's tipped at the line, so the play will continue. No icing that time. It'll be Wade Redden, however, who'll take it for Canada and flip it ahead. And he got the puck out, but no rush resulting. 2:48 left to play in the period. Littner shot it over the Canadian line. Fired back out. They're cautious now. Being careful, getting the puck out and down the ice. Chara on again, seeing a lot of ice time. He's the workhorse for this team, just like in Ottawa. Seaback centered one. Maybe not a great move. He might have had a shot himself. Samik was out of position. Flipped into the glove of Brodeur, and he'll slow the pace here by hanging on.
These two teams have played each other in international tournaments lately, and you can see by the scores in the last three that they've been one-goal wins. Canada won two of them in the World Championships in 0-2. Of course, the Slovaks won the gold medal.
Adam Foote tries to clear it, successful, but this will result in another face-off in the Canadian zone with 2 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in the first period. Thornton and Smith, the goal scorers.
Martin Saint-Louis, the only undrafted player on the Canadian team, and he had a long road to the National League and to the Stanley Cup. He says, if you've never stood in the rain, you'll never appreciate the sunshine, and he really enjoyed being a critical part of the Tampa Stanley Cup team.
Rays and rays sunshine for that young man during that last season. Scrambled play in front of the net, cleared out the center again. He nearly caught up to it. Richards up with him. Brad Richards blocked the first pass, and then Gagne lost it. Canada back, leading 2-0. Look at the speed of Draper. He got in a hurry and touched that. No, I guess he didn't. He thinks he did. He says he did, but the linesman says, I don't think so. He wins.
Well, I think the linesman missed that one because Draper got there first and stuck. Didn't move the puck, but touched it. You don't have to touch it with your stick. You can touch it with your skate, too. And the Canadian team will penalize the length of the rink on that call. Let's see if he did touch it here now. He's first by a mile. Yes, he did.
So with a minute 32 left, another face-off to the left of Martin Brodeur. Shots are 8-7, Canada. Draper now. Hang on to it, they get going. He kind of comes back inside the line, watching Niedermeyer play it the other way. Doan knifed it away, and it's down the ice again. Got it through center, and they move up on the play. Hossa knocked it down with his glove and went around the net with it. Hossa with Nagy. Nagy backed it up for Hossa. Tries to come in. Dimitris in there. Stepping in front of him was Draper. He read that play beautifully and got the puck out. 50 seconds left in the period. Slovakia looking for one. Just one. Shot in by Marian Hossa. Picked up Devereaux. Oh, what a chance that was for that one goal. Brodeur stopped it again. Wide open. And a great chance to score. Only 30 seconds left in the period. Niedermeyer flipped it back. There's Chatin. He's out with a pass to Chara. And he rifled one that was blocked. And it comes all the way back to center ice. Once again, they're moving up. Slovakia looking better now as the period wears down. Only 12 seconds left, and Canada will relieve the pressure a bit here by getting it down the ice. That'll do it. As it's shot to center ice, and the clock winds down. Maybe one more shot. No, not from Hossa. Siren goes. That's it. The shots were even. Eight apiece. Canada with a great start and got two goals. Slovakia came back, though. So look for them to have a better second period. After 20 minutes, Canada 2, Slovakia nothing.
This portion of World Cup of Hockey on CBC. Brought to you by Dodge and your Dodge retailers. Grab life by the horns.
Introducing the Home Gardener Gutter Blaster. Its water pressure trigger and changeable nozzle let you do anything from watering hanging plants to full-scale jet blasting. Plus, it extends, so you can clean your eaves with ease. You can only get the Gutter Blaster at your local home hardware or home building center. And, like every quality home gardener tool, it's fully guaranteed. Get it today for only $19.97. Home Hardware. Hell is close to home.
Back at the Bell Center, Team Canada with a 2-0 lead over Slovakia. Ryan Smith had the second goal. Ryan, so much for waltzing through the preliminary round games. What is it with the intensity of Team Canada this evening? And can you sustain it, which was a problem last night?
Well, I think the excitement from last night is carrying forth on tonight's game. And, you know, the energy at home here in Canada is so exciting. And, you know, we sort of lacked a little bit of effort there in the end. But, you know, we got to re-energize ourselves here in the second.
You know, if you win tonight, you go back to Toronto right after the game with home ice advantage for that quarterfinal elimination round game. You don't have to leave Toronto then till the end of the tournament. How much is Team Canada focused on home ice?
Well, I think it's important every game to improve, to get better, and, you know, home ice is great. But by and large, we just want to get used to each other here in the preliminary rounds to get us set, you know, for the final stages.
Thanks, Ryan.
Thank you.
Ryan Smith, the Team Canada standby for Around the World with Kelly Rudy, Brian Burke, and Ron McLean. After one period at the Bell Center, it's Team Canada 2, Slovakia no scores. We continue with World Cup 2004 on CBC.
Hello.
Hi, Mom. It's me.
Hi, honey. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm fine. How's Dad?
Dad's great. He's busy as usual. Are you eating okay?
Yeah, plenty.
Studying hard, I'm sure.
Of course.
How's your money holding out?
It's great.
Okay.
I should really get back to work, so.
I'll talk to you on Sunday.
Love you.
Bye, honey.
Bye. Mom?
Yeah?
I really miss you.
I really miss you too.
CIBC Online Banking makes it easy to take care of the things that matter.
That's my mom.
Don't miss the last Brick Tent Sale of the Year, happening this final week at The Brick. Everything in the tents is dramatically reduced. Plus, you don't pay for 15 months and get same-day delivery. Buy it today. The Brick can deliver it today.
Hey, Johnny, what was your greatest hockey moment?
Being inducted in the Hall of Fame, Mike.
Tony?
That's easy. 1970, 15 shutouts. And what about you, Mike?
Simple, playing for a hometown lease.
How you doing, guys? Good. Just some beer. You know, I'm not a bad goalie myself. Huh? I got close to your record last year. 12 shutouts.
Really?
What league was that?
Men's league.
Men's league?
You guys laughing. It's A division.
Hey, Frank, just stick to making great beer.
Throw it.
Hey! Three great goalies, three great beers. Steelback, Tango, and Chain.
Sony and The Brick present a home theater price breakthrough. Presenting the Sony Grand Vega 50-inch LCD rear projection television. Now at The Brick, you save $700 because the matching stand is free. That's a $700 value, free.
Around the World with Kelly Rudy and Brian Burke. Brought to you by Kia. Come out ahead.
Back at the Bell Center, it's 2-0 Canada after 20 minutes of play, and the best seat in the house belonged to Sandra Quinn. Pat's wife was watching right where Stanis playing goal and saw two quick goals, so she's got to be happy. And tell what you said at the BC Hall of Fame induction.
The BC Hockey Hall of Fame induction. Pat was there with Sandra, and I said to the crowd, I'd like to acknowledge my old boss. Hi, Sandra.
What did you think of the period, Kelly?
I actually thought it was quite even though Canada's winning 2-0. Slovakia had some pretty decent chances, and Brodeur just outplayed Stana. I was also surprised. Hossa was very quiet in that first period. He's a terrific player.
What do you think?
I think the same thing. I think we got the benefit early. Canada jumped out, got a couple good goals, but I thought the Slovakian team battled back and played a good second half of the period.
One thing is certain, and we'll try to get footage of this. If we ever get Marion's dad in the games, we should be worried, because he can wire a puck. He's 50 years old, František Hossa. It was unbelievable. Here's the first goal. Joe Thornton kick-started Canada's attack, and we all wondered what happens to Zdeno Chara, such a normally reliable guy.
Well, this is, I was again surprised by this play, because Chara, as we know, is a terrific defenseman, but in my mind, he's a little bit nonchalant on this play, and Thornton comes behind. I know, Brian, you have a different opinion, so go ahead.
I think he was nonchalant, but I also think his teammates have to talk to him there. He's got pressure from behind. You can't see that. There's no way you can spot a player who's chasing you from behind. His teammates have to yell to him there, heads up, someone's on you.
They do, but I still think that with his presence and hockey mind, he should know that somebody's chasing him down in his own zone.
And the proof is the puck ended up in the net. You see, right. We got a little help. Joe got a little help on a pick there, too, after he stole the puck. But I think the teammates have to speak. Even if the building's loud, they've got to make noise so their teammate knows what's happening.
Is that a condition of early in the year and guys that don't know each other?
Could be. And again, maybe they thought he was out of trouble. But you got to yell there. You got to speak to your teammates. It's important. Yeah.
Ryan Smith's goal, Kelly.
Well, I just thought it was a great play by Foote at the blue line, because Gavrik is in great position right there, and Foote just simply throws it behind the net, because I feel Team Canada working down low well. Suchi, I have no idea. He made Ryan Smith's decision there for him, and this is the one goal that I don't think Stana played very well, because in my mind, if a goalie gets beat on a wraparound, that's a poor play. If you can't cover the lower part of the net, then you're at fault.
But the defenseman can't chase there. He's got to wait. You're not going to catch a skilled forward behind the net chasing like that. You've got to wait.
Lasik's the guy that won the World Championship 2 years ago. He's played in just about every major international key game for Slovakia. You like Stana?
I do. I think he has the potential to be a really solid goaltender.
And, you know, this has been unbelievable blitzkriegs by Canada, although they only had the 8 shots. But 2 periods in a row to start games, they've absolutely been flying. And yet you're saying Marion Gavrik's faster than any Canadian?
I think the fastest player on the ice tonight is Marion Gavrik. You saw it on the breakaway chance. He got a lovely outlet pass. But this kid has missile fuel for blood. He's the fastest skater on the ice, in my opinion, maybe in the whole tournament.
And that's why Robin Regier has to take care of that and stomp it out. Let's have a look at a good clip of Gavrik's first chance and then a second, which is Brodeur.
Well, and the one that, why I think the play, this is the one where St. Louis had a chance, but I thought the Slovak player right there shouldn't have gone down to block the shot, but on the Gavrik play where he's going to get nailed by Regier, why I think it's important what Regier does, we'll find it here, but because Canada's winning 2-0 at the time, and that's a break the will of the Team Slovakia right there. You hit them and you drive them into the boards, and you prove to those guys that if you want to come back, this is how hard the game's going to be.
Brewer also had a nice hit early, but
here it is.
Yeah.
So there's the pass at the top of the screen. Now, Gavrik gets a great chance, Brodeur a great save, and here's that hit. That is punishing hockey.
That is a type of hit where he's made the shot, the defenseman stays with it and just pins him. That's a big-time hit.
How about this pass by Stumpel, too? And he's a guy as well that I think can offer more.
It's a lovely outlet pass to a guy who, when he gets the puck, he's even with the Canadian players, pulls away, gets a scoring chance, and Marty Brodeur makes not only a great first save, but a nice second save.
Because he took that extra step out to get to the top of the crease and take even more of the angle away.
Chara, another big hit here on Simon Gagné, just to be fair to Chara, because he's just a huge presence. You know, you're seeing in this game tonight the long and short of beating the odds, because he was 6'9", nobody said he could play, had to come to Prince George to really get noticed.
And he's been the most physical player on their side, but I don't think that they're hitting as much as Team Canada so far.
His draft year, they drafted Zdeno Chara of the Islanders. They didn't see him live. They got tape of him. Marshall Johnson watched the tape. They said if he's still available, we're going to take him. So it was an excellent pickup.
That's a good point. Kudos to him, and he also got him over to Ottawa. So Marshall Johnson, a former Olympian, really was a key in his career. And I was thinking of Marty St. Louis, as Harry's mentioned, undrafted, the only guy on Team Canada. So there's a tall guy and a little guy, both prove your dreams can come true. How about a guy who's hoping to get his chance, but you would never bring him up and let him play, Yaroslav Obsu.
I love this.
We got to mention Yaroslav Obsu. This is a player that Vancouver signed a year ago. He played in Winnipeg with our farm team, and we brought him in not only to be a call-up for our team, but because he's such a character guy and to work with our young defenseman. He's going to be a coach in Slovakia someday, I predict. He's a wonderful young man. We called him up 3 times. He never got to play a game.
Where is he playing this year, you said?
He's going to play in Luleå in northern Sweden.
Number 43. We'll get some good action from him. All right. The big news out of the day-to-day outside of the tournament, and I think they're trying to keep it tournament focused, but it would be nice to have a positive announcement, and that's a 9-hour meeting with the league and the PA today, and they are planning to meet again tomorrow. Brian, you've been in the throes of all of this, so what should we read out of that?
Well, it has to be a positive. The fact that they're talking where they weren't hardly speaking at all, and now they're spending three solid long days in negotiation, you have to take that as a positive. They can't spend that kind of time and not make some progress.
Do you have an inkling on what where the groundbreaking may be? Is it on revenue sharing? Is it on some form of breakaway from the cap talks? Have you heard anything?
I haven't. I think that my guess is that both the PA and the league have focused on not talking too much about it because the media coverage will detract from this tournament. So I don't think you're going to see much discussion.
All right. Yeah. Thanks, gents. I want to wish Jean Beliveau a happy 73rd birthday actually yesterday, but he's in the rink along with Marion Wayne.
Today.
So who's who here tonight?
Around the World with Kelly Rudy and Brian Burke. Brought to you by Kia. Come out ahead.
The wait is over. It's Kia's Drive More Clear Out, our biggest sales event of the year with unbeatable deals on great vehicles. Get 0% purchase financing plus up to $2,000 cash back. Or choose great low lease rates. All backed by Canada's best ownership coverage, including free oil changes for life. These deals won't last, so hurry into your local Kia dealer today.
What makes someone crave a Wendy's bacon mushroom melt? Is it the quarter pound of beef that's served fresh and hot from the grill? Is it the warm cheddar sauce so loaded with succulent mushrooms that your mouth waters? Or is it how it's combined with strips of hickory smoked bacon that makes it irresistible? Well, as long as it's back, who cares? Get a bacon mushroom melt made just for you today. Only at Wendy's. It's better here. And our pickup window is open late.
Mars Bar asks, what are you going to do with your energy?
Conquer the backwoods.
Feel the sunshine coming down. I just gotta get out of bed. Feel the good vibes all around. Well, can you hear me say?
Are you a cousin, Billy?
Do you want me to be?
Well, I sure am.
What a beautiful day.
Recharge on Mars.
Ever come, better give me what I want. I'm a kryptonite. It's growing strong. It's growing strong again. The consequences.
Back on a beautiful day to start September here in Montreal, it's Crescent Street along with Bishop and St. Catharines, the scene of what was like a Stanley Cup party after the game last night in town. It'll be the same mood this evening, Canada leading 2-0 here. A reminder, tomorrow we're back on the air with a doubleheader. Finland-Germany is game one at 1:30 Eastern. We'll follow that with Russia versus USA. Canada with a win tonight will lock up home ice. They just have to stay ahead of the Americans in order to play at the Air Canada Centre the rest of the way. Second period action on the way with Bob Cole, Harry Neal next.
A new stick for Matthew Renzoni, $22. New pads for Jeffrey Garbig, $92. A new mouth guard for Josh Burkholder, $15. A new hockey season for the Scoville Clippers, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard, hockey fan and sponsor of the World Cup of Hockey.
Here you go, boys. Here you go. Get the scent. Go find him, boys.
Introducing the award-winning Outlander Max. It can handle extra tough conditions and one or two riders. Thanks to its exclusive convertible seat rack system.
I guess someone's got a long walk back.
Guess so.
Don't get stuck with anything less. Bombardier ATV. Follow no one. Now with 3 years of free extended coverage.
Someone said it was cool.
I would not wear something because I heard it was cool.
I would never wear something.
Nothing. I never wear something
because I heard it was cool.
I do what's right for me.
Everyone does what they want.
I'm not afraid to be myself.
I'm not afraid to be myself.
I am who I am.
I am who I am.
I am who I am.
If I stand out, whatever.
So what?
If I stand out,
I stand out.
Stand out.
So what?
That's me.
I'm me.
That's me.
Whatever.
That's me.
Me.
Every driver appreciates Jeep Liberty's legendary four-wheel drive capability. Because you never know when your on-road driving is going to be a little off.
CFL on CBC returns with the annual Labor Day Classic. First, it's a Western showdown as the Eskimos battle the Stampeders. Then, the Argos tackle the Ticats. The Labor Day Classic. Monday, starting at 3:30 Eastern. The CFL on CBC.
Welcome back to the second period here at the Bell Center in Montreal. Thornton got the first goal for Canada at 3:02. And Smith got the second at 4:43. Thornton's goal and assisted, and Foot with an assist on Smith's goal along with the Cavalier. The shots were even 8 apiece, and Slovakia looked sharper toward the end of that first period. So let's see what happens here at the beginning of the second. Puck is into the Canadian zone all right rather quickly, and Thornton was back to pick it up. They don't get it out right away. Kept in by Nagy, and then he lost a chance. Doan moves up over center, and then over the line he goes. Doan with the brakes on. The pass goes right to the net. And Stena was careful on that short side as it was deflected right to him.
Well, the most dangerous Slovak was Gabber. He had 3 shots on goal, and one of them was a breakaway. This guy has lightning speed, and Broder had to make a big save there, and another one on Chatan. And then a pass into the middle of the rink by Ginla ended up on Gabbert sticking in the inner to score.
Brewer kept the puck in. Lemieux trying to center. Back down for Slovakia. They get away across center. Gabbert is up again with a shot. That hit a stick and went away wide. Trying to get it. Was Stumpel but failed. Keep it in. Gabbert just missed that. And back down for Ginla. He's coming in there. Put going in on goal, and he deflected that one right at the net, and Stena made a brilliant stop. Bentzman joining the rush rather quickly, back near the line. Foot backs off, puck will come out all right, but Gaborik is coming in on him. Look at him go, Gaborik, and out comes Brodeur to make a big move to get the puck away from Gaborik before he could do any damage. It is shot back in onside. Slovakia, however, was changing. Canada allowed to move up on open ice. San Luis, a quick shot. Rebound was there, taken away by Samick. He got it out. Now as far as center, Samick picked it up and went in. Then he lost it. Hook checked at the blue line. And Redden takes over for Team Canada. Pass to center ice. Dunk was Gagne. They let that one go. Stena on the net. Fired it away. Petko hoped to pick it up. He didn't. Around the net. Seaback the other way. And Hannon, number 23 for Canada, just fed the pass ahead across the two lines.
Well, Adam Foote had a great chance to score, and I want you to see where he started to think offense. Well, way back in his own end of the rink. And here he goes right up the middle of the rink now, and he sees that they have an on-man rush, and he beats the back checker, gets a lot of wood on it, but can't put it by the goaltender. But a nice decision by Foote to get into the rush, and he nearly scored.
Some great speed displayed there by the defenseman. Adam Foote at the goalpost last night against the U.S. Team Canada on the rush to keep it in. Flipped around the net by Hlinka. Center, right in the goal mouth area, down to Stena. And he somehow keeps that out, and Heatley was right in there close, so was Le Cavalier.
Ryan Smith couldn't find the handle as he was around the crease, too. Have a look at it right here. Le Cavalier centers it. There's Smith. He kicks it up to his stick and gets another shot at it. but he can't get it by Stana. Blocks anything along the ground here, or along the ice. And there's Smith. He knows where it is, but he can't get it.
From the blue line, shot doesn't get too far. Tipped out by Sterbak. Nagy, rink wide with it. That's up high over the net and over Brugger's high glove. Canada defending now, trying to move it out. They'll be carried out by Brewer. Nice pass down there, open ice. And Draper rifled it right on the net. Stana just stood up to it. Again, from the boards, another shot. Doesn't reach the goaltender that time. It is Foot with a shot. Right in front of the net, Stana down. What a glorious scoring opportunity. Foot took the shot, but kind of off the heel of his stick.
And then Shane Doan had a great opportunity as the puck slid to him, and he didn't get much of it. Watch Doan number 9 come into the right of Stana. Right there. Went off his skate right up to his stick, and then he couldn't get the puck before it was under the goaltender.
Canada pounding away on the offense. Shots are 6-0. Behind the net is Lemieux, kicked it loose in the corner to Winginlaw. He's body checked off the puck and fell. And bringing it back out. Obstoot. Got it in there, wide of the net, tipped away. Gaborik nearly got a chance, but away goes Aginla. Coming down. Aginla again up over the line with Mario going to the net. The shot is whistled wide, down low, but wide of the net. Sackett goes over in front of the goal. Aginla couldn't get it to him, so now he looks for it along with Mario Lemieux. Lemieux back for Sackett. Sackett turning the other way. He's hammered in on the boards by Obstoot. Goes around the net to the other side. Finally, they get it out. Joining the rush was Obstoot. Rifled it in. That's the sign to make the changes. Aginla is open. He's been on a while, so he shoots it in and takes off to the bench. 16 minutes left in the second already. A fast 4 minutes in the second. San Luis center. Score!
Last second got his stick on a pass from Martin St. Louis that was deflected by the Slovakian defenseman. Changed direction, and a great example of good hand-eye coordination by Gagne, because the pass didn't come directly to him. Here's St. Louis passes. There it goes off the stick, and Gagne very quickly got his stick on it and tipped it in on the backhand.
Beautiful by St. Louis. It's a very quick line Canada has on there now. St. Louis, Gagne, and Richards. This is Gagne. Puck is deflected away, though, and it's cleared out of the zone by Orsak. Down the ice it goes. Slovakia is changing again, but here comes Radivojevic. He won't catch his man. Canada moving out. They're ahead 3-0 now. Down over the Slovakia line. Played back to the blue line and in around the net they go. Good passing by Canada, but however, at the line, Gere had made an extra move and came in a little bit too deep. And he had no chance to pick it up. It was wide open too, lots of ice over there. Now they're back in again. Relentless attacking. He's allowed to go. Richards is going to the bench on a change. Sterbak. Smith on him quickly. He had to hurry the pass out. He got it on the glass and did get it out. Dimitri knocked it down in over the line. The shot is stopped. Rebound. And then fired wide of the empty net behind Brugger. He was out a little bit. Dimitri stopped it again and poked at it. In along the board. They keep it deep. Nagy. And Hossa. Hossa stopped. Again, they fight for it. It is Nagy doing pretty good work back there. Centering pass, play stop. They got it called. Penalty called by Walkham in deep.
Brewer's going to get the penalty for slashing, and the Slovaks will go on the power play. Nagy and Brewer fought in the defensive zone coverage for quite a while, and there is the trip for the slash, and the referee called desperately in need of a goal. The Slovaks, who have had one shot this period, get a chance on the power play to cut the deficit.
They better get one here. They're down 3-0 now. They win the faceoff. Vishnovsky fed it off on the boards, cleared in by Orsog. Right in front of Brodbury. He snapped at it quickly, though, with a stick before any damage could be done. Backing it off is Sterbak. Again, Canada with a chance to clear. No mistake. Off the glass in the corner and down the ice.
Canada's penalty killing in the exhibition games, plus last night against the United States, one goal against, 17 times short.
Chatan brought it in all right, but Gabrick on this near side is offside.
Another penalty, I think, coming up here. Gabrick was tripped on the blue line. Or no, he's going to get the penalty.
Yes.
As he was running a little interference on the rush into the Canadian zone.
That's not a very good penalty. He's had the power play going now. They're down 3-0.
Well, let's have a look and see how it happened. Right there, you see, he's coming along the line and bumps into the Canadian defenseman. And they call it tripping, but it probably should be interference. But not a very bright move by a fairly bright player.
No. So a little bit of room out there for the speedsters to take advantage. Let's see what happens. Tip down to the Canadian line. Adam Foote backing up. San Luis. Other side, rink wide, a dandy pass. And they move it up on the boards high, but it went a little too high and offside anyway by Hannon. Playing his first game.
When you love someone, you sacrifice. Give it everything you got.
Soon, friends, families, and thousands of CIBC employees will join together to create a future without breast cancer. Who are you running for? Join us Sunday, October 3rd. When you love someone.
With Canada's best warranty and special clear-out prices, now is the best time to get your hands on a Hyundai. Special clear-out prices and Canada's best warranty. At Hyundai, you win.
Why don't you get us some snacks?
Okay. Two hot dogs, please. Two hot dogs!
Peanuts! Get your peanuts!
Drink it all.
Bob Goodnow and Gary Batman met for 9 hours today, and they'll meet again tomorrow. The length of time might suggest they've broken new ground, but perhaps not. We're told they're going team by team, trying to agree on the financial state of each, and that's what's taking the time. The extended meeting hours don't necessarily mean either side has changed its position on the fundamental issue of cost certainty. But as long as they're talking, I suppose there's hope, Bob.
Yes, okay, Scott. Not much changed, I don't believe. And they'll continue to meet. That pass just out of the reach in front of the net. Draper's had some pretty good chances, and this is first game. Shot is off the stick and high and wide to the glass. Draper's headed off to the bench on a quick change. Doan takes the puck from the corner, and the shot. Fired right on. Doan made a dandy play by getting it out. He saw Richards come from the bench quickly.
And Richards one-timed it. And that was a big-time save by the goaltender. As Doan makes a nice play from behind the net, Richard came off the bench, and he's right in the slot. Lets it go, and it deflected off Chara and changed direction. Stana still got a little equipment on it.
Slovakia without a goal so far, and we're coming up to the 8-minute mark in the second period. Canada has three of them. Slovakia on the attack, and moving in was Josef Stempel. He's got Chatan with him on the boards. They can't hang on to the puck. Canada regrouping and coming down hard as San Luis trying to stick handle by the two defensemen. Richards was there with him. He failed. Stumpel again dropped it back. Richards watched that play develop. And he made a good move to tap it in for San Luis. He fell, seeing the hit coming from Obsut. There's Aguinla with the puck under control on the boards. Flipped it in to open ice along the boards behind the net. And Stumpel a chance to clear, doesn't. Ginless pass. That was tipped out by Chatan. Ginla again. Goes to center. Richards. Oh, look at that pass. Easily picked off at the blue line. And cleared down the ice by Vishnovsky. Canada attacking once more. Sackick tried the backhand pass. Lemieux was up there. Lost it. Tapped down to center ice. And up there was Seaback, but couldn't get too far. Again, laying there again. Here's Sackett coming in. Mario right behind him. And the pass tipped away, but at the blue line stop. Shot in there wide of the net. Good pressure again by Lemieux, Sackett, and Aguinla. Aguinla bumped by Vishnovsky. And he gets rid of it. Got it as far as center ice. Big Brewer was there to knock it down. They can't play it back in. Now a second chance. They do get it in. Skrbak. For Slovakia. Again, coming to the side of the net and backing up Art Petchko. He left it. Seaback returns it for him at center ice and he's away. Up over the line, played it back in front, then Sonic to stop. Open ice on this near side. It is the Speedy Heatley coming in. Fires! Rebound! Knocked down by the goalie and then clear to the corner. And they dig it out. Cavalier gets it back to bottom foot and winding up again. That's block. Here's another chance. Canada hope to get better every game. I think they've improved tonight over last night.
9-1 they're out shooting the Slovaks in the second period.
Unreal. Slovakia. They get a second shot. And there's Martin Brodeur.
So Martensko made a big time shot block on Adam Foote, who walked in to the top of the circle. And may have saved a goal because there was a big crowd you can see in front of the net. And who knows whether the goaltender would have seen it. Those forwards block shots, you know the intensity level is high.
It's great hockey. Start of the year, September the 1st, and they're flying. Brodeur sharp. Steady as a rock. Penalty coming. A hook.
It's going to go to the Slovaks.
Oh, yes.
So Canada will go on the power play. I think it's Orsak who's going to get the penalty. He tripped the Canadian player coming out of the zone. Right there. He hooked Scott Hannon off his feet as Hannon was going to clear the zone with the puck. So Canada goes on the power play again.
This will be their fourth power play. They've had three coming in with this one and only one shot. Everything else has been working though. Working well. Just past the halfway mark. This penalty. Setting the Slovaks in another hole. Down 3-0. Steal this off. Radivojevic fired it around the net. It's going to be kept in by Canada. Thornton was there, left it behind the goal. He gets open in this near corner. Pass goes to the line. Sackett tried to hammer one, didn't get all of it. And it shot down the ice, and Joe Sackett will be back to pick it up. Long pass gets up there. Danny Heatley. Body checked right away and hammered away by Slovakia. 1 minute gone in this power play. Slovakia, a chance to pick it off. Seaback, he was covered immediately. He could get a shot at the net. He was on a sharp angle, fair distance anyway. Canada down. The captain, Mario Lemieux, in front of the net with a pass. Cavalier was cruising in there too. And now he's got the puck behind the net. Hammered into the boards though back there. Tries to kick it loose. Ginla did get it loose. The Lemieux picks it up, throws it back into the crowd. There is Le Cavalier. It's by him and out to the line. Stopped out there by Richards. He knew where Lemieux was and gave it to him. And he just waits. He's going to set one up here. Mark it down. To the line it goes. It comes this side. Richards comes in. Again along the line. And there's Mario once more, the quarterback. Set. A pass stop. After it again is Mario Lemieux. He stops it, kicks it loose, rolls it in on the board. Good work by Mario Lemieux. In behind the net, Le Cavalier tapped it over on the side. Richards back for him. Lemieux is over there, centered. Again. He can't buy one. It's amazing. He's getting the chances, but can't get one home.
What a pass by Le Cavalier, though.
You're watching the World Cup of Hockey on CBC Sports.
Hero is the number one movie in Canada, and the critics agree. Spectacular, an action movie for the ages. Two big thumbs up. A great movie. Hero. Now playing.
Why don't I snap my fingers to order a beer? Why don't I flush the toilet when my roommate is taking a shower? Hero. Why don't I stop volunteering these services?
Sharing with those around me. Hey.
So why don't I snap my fingers to order a beer? Because I am Canadian.
Hero is the number one movie in Canada, and the critics agree. Spectacular. An action movie for the ages. Two big thumbs up. A great movie. Hero.
Now playing.
Closed captioning is brought to you by... The new Pontiac G6, launching this fall.
Ed Jovanovski now officially out of the tournament with a fractured rib and a sprained MCL, but are you feeling at all fortunate? Initially, the reports were it could have been worse.
Yeah, I was definitely a little frightened by the whole incident. I heard a couple pops, you know, when I was going into the net, but we did a CT scan to rule out any internal organ damage, and I guess you can say, in hindsight, we'll be okay.
How soon will you be able to resume skating?
When you have a second degree MCL sprain, the timeline is 4 to 6 weeks. So, I've had one before, and so I know what to expect, and hopefully it'll be sooner than later.
Thank you, Ed. Good luck in your rehab.
All right, thanks.
Bob?
Another big defenseman gone down for Canada. They're going to miss him.
Well, every team in this tournament has lost key players, either wouldn't play after they were selected or hurt after training camp started. And you're looking at one team right here, the Slovaks, who have really been hit. The referees over at the timers bench. They have video replay officials in the tournament. They did not have them in the exhibition game. So let's have a look. This is the pass by Le Cavalier, and it goes right to a Ginlett. Does it go in the net? Well, you certainly can't tell by that one. So that's what they don't know. And they have to clearly see the puck in the net to count it. The Canadian team did not complain at all originally, so this was a investigation started by the video goal judge.
Joe Thornton, who scored the first goal of the game. On there winning the faceoff, but Slovakia steals the puck and gets it out. Thornton was up there, saw it go high over his head, and then he kind of intercepted the pass. Here's Doan getting a chance, and he's tied up. Tried to make the move over in front to Thornton, who was coming in. Demikra gets it out off a skate to center ice, and Doan again stop that and shot it in for Chris Draper. Draper comes in. It comes to Doan. Back into Draper. Thornton behind the net. Fired away by Littner, though, off the other side. Doesn't get out. Not near out. Kept in by Team Canada. Thornton is covered. Moving up again. From the blue line was Niedermayer, and Demikra saw him and got it out of the zone. Niedermayer got back, but Nagy picks it up and comes on. Nagy fired a pass over in front, but his teammates were changing, and there was nobody over there to pick it up.
Kara dumps it in. 7 minutes left in the second period. 3-0 Canada is your score. One goal here in the second by Gagne from San Luis. Beautiful play. Cross center. Dolan again shoots it in. Long shift for him. He's going now to the bench. Lemieux takes the body check but gets the puck in deep. Played out to Gavrik. He tried to move away from McGinley, couldn't do it. Chetan fired it across the ring. Broken up again, and there's McGinley. Lost it, but they'll go anyway. Again, it's Foot joining the rush. Shooting it in, taking a hit from offsuit, but got it in deep. Stopped at the line and knocked down in front. McGinley again. McGinley second time and turning to Joe Sakic. Sakic comes back, gives it to McGinley. He lifted the stick. They keep it in, around the net, coming out, Sakic in the crease area, fires it over there, but that's intercepted and cleared out. Stumpel got a stick in front of the pass. Oh, what a glove save by Brodeur. I'm going to tell you something, that was just a calm play, ripped by Chetan, and Brodeur again.
Introducing a new way to make tea using a time-honored tradition. Loose tea leaves. The secret to great tasting tea is allowing the water to surround the tea leaves, coaxing out every last drop of flavor. So, Tim Hortons had a third generation tea master design the ideal tea steeper, which gently steeps the tea. For a perfect pot, every time. Tim Hortons new steep tea. Great tasting tea, every time.
Always fresh at Tim Hortons.
The GMC Sierra. With Duramax Diesel and Allison Transmission. Legendary torque. Introducing the GMC Canyon, with an inline 5 that has more power than any V6 in its class. It's the midsize that thinks bigger.
All across the country, people are signing up for the new CIBC Unlimited Checking Account.
I signed up.
There you go, because they're tired of getting dinged with unexpected service charges.
No kidding.
Right, so now every transaction, withdrawal, bill.
Every debit, check.
All covered with one flat monthly fee.
But just online, right?
Everywhere. At the branch, at their bank machine.
On the phone.
At the store. It's all covered. It's a CIBC Unlimited Checking Account.
Hey, did you say unlimited checking?
Yeah, no, not that kind of checking.
Introducing the new CIBC Unlimited Checking Account. No limits, no surprises.
Brodeur robs Miro Chetan on a shot here with a great stop. Chetan, who led Buffalo in scoring 3 straight years and led this team when they won the World Championship in 02 in scoring. So he knows where the net is, does Chetan.
That was headed in just inside the post. That was a beautiful glove save. There's Brodeur going to work again with the goal save. Cleared that one away. Cheaply fell. Brodeur comes out of the net. He saw Smith coming back, and Smith gets the puck out. Skrbak. Skrbak again for Slovakia. Up to Bert, Ketchko by him. Down the ice. Ketchko in after it. Side of the net. Underside. Samek tried to give it to him. Back up to Samek. Bert Ketchko was there with him, the two of them. Bert Ketchko picks it up and centered it. And Seaback just missed it. There's going to be a penalty to Team Canada.
Cavalier's going to get it, I think, as he interfered with the Seaback was going to the net and in good position to take a pass. And here it is right here. There's the slash across the stick. And here's a better look at it. So it's a slashing call right there. And it may have prevented a goal because that puck was coming right onto the stick of Seaback.
Now it's only the second power play for Slovakia. And they're looking for the first shot with the man advantage. Is this it? Yes. And a nice save by Brodeur. Along the board, Slovakia trying to get position. They do. Into the corner, Dimitra. Again, Dimitra takes it. Looks back to the point. Gives it to Vychara. He fires it at the net. Brodeur down. Back up. It's cleared again out of harm's way. 3-0 Canada with 4:50 left in the second period. Second game for Canada, defeated the United States last night 2-1. Slovakia, their first game tonight here in Montreal. This play goes offside.
Well, Chara, who had a great year last year, second in the Norris Trophy voting, the first NHL All-Star team. And since he joined Ottawa, he has had a combined plus 92 in three seasons. The most improved defenseman I've seen since I saw him play his first game with the Islanders. He has come a mile and a half.
There's Richards coming up in a shorthanded situation, decided to keep going though. Stallings, Sirback, who finally made the play. And now down to center ice. Coming across the line, Vishnovsky lays it in a little bit too far for Snepple. He had to go back to pick it up and now has it in the corner, goes around the net to Gavrik, circling the net. Tried to hit it by Brodeur to the far side, nearly did. They spread out now on this power play unit. Vishnovsky, other side for the shot. Brodeur saw it coming, moved out to cut the angle, made the save. It's not out, but now it is cleared by Brad Richards. 40 seconds left on this power play, Slovakia. And they're deep in their own zone. Good work by Doan in forechecking. Great work by Doan, but however, they get it up and down the side. They come in, Kutan with the brakes on. Feeds it back near the line. And again, they spread out. Power play is nearly done, 20 seconds left on it. Vishnovsky handles it, lays it back in. Dimitra takes it off the boards. He's stopped by Brewer. Got it again, side of the net, centering pass, cleared down the ice. Canada covering up for the goalie, Martin Brodeur. 5 seconds left on the power play. That's it. 3:16 left to play in the second. The Cavalier is out of the penalty box. Three shots on Brodeur as they made a bid for their first goal. A high shot. Way high. Niedermayer. Getting it back. Shovel up on the boards and down the ice by Scott Hannon. And there's the Cavalier with a hit, giving Heatley a chance to move the puck out in front of the net, and he does. The Cavalier has set up perfect and didn't hit the net with a shot. Cavalier again takes it off the boards, looks around, he sees Heatley over in front, back to the line, and a bit too far for Hannon. He had moved toward the center ice area. Shot away, down the ice. Hannon backs up at his own line and tried to knock it out. Now he takes it, and he'll give it to Niedermayer. Now to center. Heatley, stop, got it again, stopped again. Sakic looks and shoots the puck in deep. Lemieux and Ginla are on the ice again with Sakic. 2 minutes left to play in period number two. Seaback gets the puck out to center ice. Down they go. Sonic drifted one in, gloved by Brodeur, held on to, and 1:52 remaining.
Well, one of the assistant coaches, Franisek Hossa, is the father of Marcel Hossa, who plays for Montreal, and obviously Marian Hossa, who plays for Ottawa. After this tournament, he will return to Slovakia and coach the national team. So hockey has been a large part of the Hossa family's life. Must be a thrill to coach your son in this kind of a tournament.
Adam Foote was upended. The play continues. And Canada gets the puck as far as Radivojevic, who's stopping. In it goes for Orzov. Side of the net. Had to back off to the corner a bit. Flipped in around the goal by Holinka. Back is fourth line on, setting it up for Chara's shot. Here comes Radivojevic, by him, kept in by Lichtner all the way. Centered in the blue ice, and cleared to the corner and swept out. As far as the line, but not all the way out. Another penalty coming up.
Malenka got involved with Brodeur.
Scrap here.
Malenka for the Slovaks got involved with Brodeur, and you know what happens. Matt Quinn was upset with the American team, thinking that they were after Martin Brodeur with the man going to the net. This is the first time it's cropped up in this game, and I'm pretty sure that Halenka's going to get the penalty. I don't know whether any other ones.
One punch was thrown.
Well, here it is, number 30, Halenka. digs at Broder. Now he comes back out in front and interferes with him. As you can see, knocks the stick out of Broder's hand, and Regeer comes in to challenge him. So we're going to have more than one penalty, I think. But maybe not. Certainly, Halenka's going to get one for goaltender interference.
So far, that looks like it. The other gate has not been opened. So Halenka. It's just the one, Halenka.
267th pick overall by Florida, 97. He's played last year for Moscow Dynamo in the Russian Elite League.
Suki has the puck up there for Slovakia. Stalls a bit. We have now just 1 minute left in the second period. Canada 3, Slovakia nothing. Power play. Canada moving out. In it goes by Le Cavalier. Stumble on there first. Tried to flip it behind the net. It'll be cleared out by Chetan. Lots of time to move it. He got it up to Josef Stumpel. He circles back. Nearly lost it and now loses it. 2-on-1. Right in again, Aguila, and can't buy a goal. That's about 5 times in the first 2 games that he's been in there so close.
Well, Stumpel had a chance to ice the puck. But oh no, he's going to give a little stick handling demonstration. He's stripped of the puck in the 2-on-1 rush. One pass back to Aguila, lets it go. And Stana makes a great save on that brain cramp by Stumpel.
Aguila remains on with Le Cavalier, winning the draw. Back to the blue line, Sakic. New takes the pass, winds up, fires. Didn't miss by much. Sakic kept it in. Now it's outside the line. Seabach checked his man and moved it. Seabach is up there for checking, but Canada brings it out. Only 10 seconds left for Lemieux. Faked at the blue line to go back a bit and then shot it in. Then he was hit. 5 seconds remaining. Scramble on the board. 3 players on it. That'll do it back there in the corner. The siren closes out this second period. Shots were 13 by Canada and 9 by Slovakia. 21-17 over 2 periods. Canada got the only goal, Gagne, and they lead 3-0.
Do you have the right truck? North America's best-selling half-ton regular. And extended cab. Is now available as a crew cab. It's got more standard horsepower, more torque, and more towing capacity than Ford or Dodge half-ton crews. Introducing the new Silverado half-ton crew. It's the right truck from Chevy.
Canada has spoken. The greatest Canadian. The list revealed this fall on CBC television.
With Slovak assistant captain Pavel Dimitra and Pavel, Marian Gaborik told one interviewer at the end of the first period that even though you guys were down 2-0, he felt the two teams were fairly even. Can you still say that now after 2?
Well, you know, they got a good lead and they score from our mistakes. And we just have to, you know, focusing and playing good defense. You know, they got a lot of offensive power, like, you know, in the lineup. And we just have to work hard. You never know. It's the last 20 minutes and we're just going to try to one by one.
Pavel, they have come off to 2 fantastic starts in 2 games here in Montreal. Is there anything opponents have to do better against Canada early in these games?
Like we show up, we don't really show up last 10 minutes. You know, we are not ready for 10 minutes. We talk in the dressing room. You know, they always got a strong start and they scored 2 goals. And you know, second I think we play very well and they just score 1 goal from our mistakes. And then we just have to, you know, keep. You know, puck, make sure we dump it and just, you know, play easy hockey.
Thank you, Pavel.
Thanks.
Pavel Dimitra, the Slovak assistant captain, his team down 3-0 after 2, thanks to Simon Gagne. Coming up next, Ron McLean in studio with Hall of Famer Peter Stastny, who is running the Slovak team.
Tim Hortons supports over 50,000 kids across Canada who play Timbits Hockey. It's a fun way for kids to learn the basics of the game. Timbits Hockey. The first goal is having fun.
Don't miss the last great tent sale of the year, happening this final week at The Brick. Everything in the tents is dramatically reduced. Plus, you don't pay for 15 months and get same-day delivery. Buy it today. The Brick can deliver it today.
Now there's a way to make your home phone mobile. City Fido, with unlimited local calling in the Greater Toronto Area for just $45 per month. Regrettably, only from Fido.
It's back and it's big, the 2004 Princess Margaret Hospital Foundation Colossal Cash and Cars Lottery. Watch your mailbox for this brochure. 10, yes, 10 grand prizes. Plus millions in cash prizes and 70 spectacular vehicles. Over 28,000 prizes, and your chances of winning are an incredible 1 in 12. Princess Margaret Hospital Foundation Colossal Cash and Cars Lottery. Watch for it.
It's the last great tent sale of the year. Pay no GST on all furniture and mattresses. This contemporary sofa is just $9. All wood bedroom package, only $9.99. Leather recliner, just $1.99 at The Brick.
Back at the Bell Center, 3-0 Canada after 40 minutes. As Elliot mentioned, Peter Stastny will join me in just a moment. Peter Ottawa has been a broadcaster. We really hear the beautiful voice he's got and, of course, some thoughts on tonight and the tournament. Danny Heatley's had a lot of great victories, one loss he'll never shake. But with team support and the refuge of his sport, he's healing, coping, and doing what he does best.
Break it in. Danny Heatley scores!
For the fifth consecutive year, Danny Heatley is representing his country. After two bronze medals as a junior, he's been a key in back-to-back world championships. He led Canada in scoring in 2003 and was named tournament MVP after a brilliant performance this past spring.
I think both of those 2003-2004, I think the biggest key was just we're such tight teams and we gelled very quickly together over there. And but both were a lot of fun in their own way. I think different guys, a lot of the same guys, but bottom line, I think we just gelled very quickly and came together quick and won those tournaments.
He's got the
Anson's overtime goal was something that I'll never forget, and just the waiting around for them to finally call it a goal, that would have to be that year. And last year, I don't know, just the whole tournament seemed to be a lot of fun. I think again we faced Sweden in the final, and we were down a couple goals and fought back.
The gold was one of the few bright spots in a year marred by tragedy. The car accident that took the life of friend and teammate Dan Snyder left Heatley burdened by grief, nursing a broken jaw and torn ligaments in his knee. With the support of the Thrashers and the Snyder family, he began 4 months of rehab.
I think I just really focused on doing it. I mean, I couldn't skate, I couldn't practice with the team, so my focus was on the rehab, and the doctors in Atlanta did a great job, and my rehab guys in Atlanta did a great job, and we all worked very hard together and got a good result.
On right wing, number 15, Danny Heatley.
Back with the Thrashers for the final 31 games of the season, Heatley regained his place as one of the top young players in the sport.
I never felt I wasn't part of the team. The organization and the guys were great. I think they really helped me out and get me through that. But I think as a player, I think I didn't feel really 100% until the World Championships last year. And that's when I really started to feel great physically.
Jam play, rebound in front of the net. Shot scores! Danny Heatley!
Well, I feel 100%. I feel great. I think I got better towards the end of the last season. The little break in between the season and the Worlds last year really helped out, and I felt good in Europe. And again, another 2 months this summer, I feel very good right now.
On the ice, Heatley looks better than ever. However, off of it, he faces charges of vehicular homicide and will be arraigned in an Atlanta courtroom 2 days after the tournament.
It's been there for the last year, basically, and there's nothing I can do about it right now. And right now, I'm just focused on playing hockey and helping this team try to win this tournament.
Now, you cheer for Danny Heatley, and you think of Danny Snyder every time. Peter Stastny has promised is with me, and it's a tough game. You had those two quick goals. Peter, what are your thoughts on Marty Brodeur, Team Canada, and your club?
Oh, Marty is excellent. You know, I was pretty happy with the first period. I actually very happy compared to the game we played in Ottawa against Canada. We jumped to two-goal lead, and they were working on their way back. But we didn't have a jump. We didn't play well. We just we executed on a couple of opportunities. That's what happened to Team Canada. First two scoring chances, they scored.
Yeah.
And you know, you could see the first period. We got scoring chances about equal. Even the hits were equal, even, which is very, very good. That's what he wanted to do against a team like the way they started yesterday was just unbelievable.
Well, you were here. You had to be pumped up. I mean, I don't know what it's like in Slovakia. When you go back to 2002 and some of your great victories in the past in Czechoslovakia, but is it the same? I know Wenceslas Square was pretty impressive when the Czechs won gold in Nagano. But
we had the same thing in Bratislava. We won the gold, and there was euphoria throughout the 5 million inhabitants of Slovakia. It was everybody just flooded the main squares. It was just fantastic.
What was the greatest game you were ever a part of internationally?
Internationally, wow, that's a tough question. Internationally, you're killing me. I got everything divided between NHL, Czechoslovakia, Slovakia, and I played the 76 Canada Cup. I always think it was one of the best tournament ever, and when we went to the overtime, and Daryl Sitter scored a goal on Zurilla there. I was a rookie, I was 19 years old, and playing against these guys, you look at the lineup, they are the legend. Everybody's in Hall of Fame, and from Bobby Hall, Esposito, Bobby Orr, just everybody. We played some great games. We dominated in the world then. We were better than Russia, Soviet Union then, and playing the finals against Canada was very memorable.
Canada has never had a defense like that defense, and Vachon played great, but to have Bobby Orr and Dennis Potvin and the big three from Montreal was unbelievable.
Players were smaller. We saw the Larry Robinson just spreading his wings, and there was no room.
Like you don't
there
have
was
that
no
with
room.
Chara.
And that was the first time for us being in the NHL. The rings are smaller,
yeah.
And I mean, we couldn't move anywhere. It was those rings were pretty filled.
This is what really upsets me, though, is you dealing with Slovakia here. If we look at this footage, I thought you were a good Canadian kid. And
a very good one.
Yeah, here you are helping us out. There's a nice pass to you with your beautiful hands. Easy, beating the Czechs. I thought you would...
Oh, that was a very important goal. You know what? We were the Team Canada was on the line. If we wouldn't win against Czechoslovakia, I was 84. We wouldn't make the semifinals. We would be out of the tournament.
Yeah.
And we were so pumped. And I think the first period was like 5-0 or something. It was all over after the first period. That was the first goal. It was very important. I love that.
That's the greatest moment. I was hoping you'd come back.
That was communist Czechoslovakia. That was communist Czechoslovakia.
And never taught
believe
that.
Me, I was always very loyal. I am competitor. Whatever jersey I have on, I'll do my best all the time.
Yeah, you do. We'll have to do this a little more during the tournament. This has only just begun, but that's a joy, a real treat. Hockey Hall of Famer and obviously the pride of Slovakia. Peter Stastny, we'll come back on our way to the third period here in Montreal.
Friends, families, and thousands of CIBC employees will join together to create a future without breast cancer. Who are you running for? Join us Sunday, October 3rd. When you love
someone. Hey, yeah, 糟糕! 这么多人在等! 去找李云迪!
Thank you. closed captioning is brought to you by Molson Canadian. It's a Canadian game.
You see the energy of Peter Stastny. If you watch this afternoon, the Czechs rebound on Sweden. It's never over. Finland, Germany, that's tomorrow's first of a doubleheader. Then Russia, USA at 7 o'clock from St. Paul. Canada, home and cool, you would think. But the third period, the Slovaks will have something in store. We'll have that and then about a half an hour with Brian Burke to argue the CBA after the third. Coming up.
You can feel it. You can taste it. And you can see it. There's more in sweat than just water. And there's more than just water in Gatorade. Gatorade quenches thirst and helps put back fluids an athlete needs.
With Canada's best warranty and special clear-out prices, now is the best time to get your hands on a Hyundai. With special clear-out prices and Canada's best warranty, at Hyundai, you win.
Quitting smoking? Nicoderm can help you double your chances of success, too. Only Nicoderm has patented smart dose technology. And hey, it's the patch most recommended by doctors and pharmacists.
Hello? Oh, hi. Mr. Wendy here, going door-to-door to remind people about Wendy's late-night pickup window.
Don't you have anything better to do?
Actually, no. Look, how many times have you been forced to eat something you didn't want late at night?
Happens all the time.
Well, from now on, go to Wendy's. They'll make you a really good classic double with cheese fresh instead of something you really didn't want anyway.
You're with Wendy's?
Well, unofficially. So is anyone else home?
Yeah. Say hi to Bruno.
Whoa. Wendy's pickup window is open late.
This portion of World Cup of Hockey on CBC, brought to you by Samsung. Experience the power within.
We're back for the third period, and Miroslav Holinka is in the box for Slovakia. 49 seconds remaining on his minor penalty. 3-0, Canada leads Slovakia. As we're set to go, Van Madsen holding at center ice, and we're underway. That is Niedermeyer coming all the way back and starting off. Up to center ice. Lemieux takes that dandy pass and comes in. He's knocked down, gets back up. Rolling around the net for Ginla, who's moving up. Ginla back that up for Le Cavalier. Out front, nice save by Stana. And then Sakic wrists one at the goal. Big rebound there again. Le Cavalier, the first one on it. Moving in there well. Le Cavalier just waits. Gives it to Lemieux at the line, and the play stopped. Penalties in front of the net. There are going to be a couple, I think.
Chara and Niedermeyer, I think, are the two players. They bumped into each other and then came back for a second attempt. So 14 seconds left in Halenka's penalty, and these two guys will go for roughing, I believe. And so for a short time, Canada still has the power. Let's have a look at it. There's the one play where Niedermeyer was dumped, and he goes back. He gets dumped again, and then he goes back for a third time. And finally, the referee had seen enough and gave both the penalty.
Chara and Niedermeyer in the box, slashing the call on both. From the blue line, the long shot off a stick to the corner. Gagne whipped it in around the net for St. Louis. Out front, trying to wrap around on that near side, was Richards. Olinka's back on. Shot from the slot coming up. There it is, score! What a pass by Richards. And it's 4-0 Canada.
Martin Saint-Louis. How many times has he and Richards got together for goals last year and in this tournament? Martin Saint-Louis leads the Canadian team in points. This is his second of the night, and he got two against Americans. And the Tampa Bay Lightning have contributed three players to Team Canada, and that's more than any other team. Let me tell you why they won the Stanley Cup.
Four nothing. Almost impossible now for Slovakia to mount an attack. That will get them four goals away. Team Canada has been playing, especially the goalie, Martin Brugger. But they're coming up. Dimitri gets a shot that stopped, and another one that went wide. Dimitri got his own rebound. And backhanded the puck high over the net. Grabber is off the boards with it. Tries to back it up in there again, and it's cleared out and down across center. Saint-Louis, his second goal in two games. Richards and Foote earning the assists. The pass by Richards was beautiful. 58 seconds was the time of the goal. Radivojevic couldn't stop that one. Scott Hannon back to touch it up. That's icing.
Well, Martin Saint-Louis is one of seven Canadian players that led their team in scoring last year. Canada has seven NHL captains on their team, 20 first-round picks, and four first overall. And I may tell you why. They are, in many people's opinion, the favorite to win this tournament.
Two won last night over the USA. They're going to win this one tonight. Handily, they're leading 4-0 now at the two-minute mark of the third period. Wrapped in by Martin Seabat. Brodeur out, shovels the puck away on this near side. And Gagné has to go back. Now they line up. Saint-Louis stumbled a bit. Now he's back on the skates and coming in looking for it. He's the first one in. It went wide of the net. Stana tried to play it. Slovakia brings it out. Seabat was checked by Gagné coming back. Carrying on goal is Bartechko. Round the goal, tries to center. He's checked from behind, and then he and Gagné bump together twice. Long shot misses the net. Saint-Louis won't get there. Dumped the head along the boards, and now batted out across the line. Richards feeds it in, and Canada will change them up. So will the Slovaks. They're approaching the third minute of the third period. Game two for Canada, the first game for Slovakia. Brewer's pass was good. Don't stop, though. And Adam Foote comes back. Chasing him is Stumpel. Got away from him. Brewer brings it up to center. Got to center. Put it in deep for Don to come in. He got it. It was cleared by Strabak, though. Not out. Canada bringing it in deep. Around the net. Center. Oh, what a chance that was for Draper. He missed it and fell. Over there is Chetan. Tries to get it out and won't get very far. It's stopped by Scott Hannon.
Joe Thornton has really improved every game, and I think he's having his best game tonight. He lays a perfect pass on Draper's stick, but Draper got tangled up and couldn't get much of a shot away. Certainly Draper's given this team a little life. Maybe the fastest skater on the team. Selke Trophy winner last year.
Detroit. Look at this. Mario, a great chance to score. And a nice save by Stana. Lemieux flipped the puck behind the net. Centered again, and Sackey just missed it, and he was in close. Canada relentless in its attack. Mario knew that would have been offside. He didn't play it. And it went down the ice, and the play continues. Up comes Littner. Shot it from center. Off the blocker of Brodeur, back out. Dimitri watched the puck over there by Skirback. Deeply nearly got loose. Pass grabbed by Dimitri, and he turns with it. Made a good move at center ice and got it up there. Littner had to hurry that one, though, and Canada takes over. But now losing it was Niedermayer. And it's fed back to the line. The shot by Skirbak is blocked. Canada gets it out of the zone. Heatley striding up there after Skirbak. He saw him, though, and got it ahead. Ovechkin coming in. Bartechko in too far for the shot that time. And then Seaback overskated it. Bartechko lost it to Brewer. Not out. Centered. Look at that. It had to be scored that time. Two of them had the chance. Seaback had the first one. And Brodeur was out of position. So they got a goal.
Well, a careless play in the Canadian zone. They had the puck, and they couldn't get it out. And Brewer gave the puck away behind the net right here, and they never got it back. Here's the first attempt, and then Seaback walks out of the corner, and Brodeur is in no position to make the save. And the Team Canada must be thinking of the game they watched this afternoon when Sweden was up 4-0 against the Czechs, and it ended up 4-3, and the Czechoslovakian Czech Republic had a lot of chances in the last minute.
Seaback gets the goal. It's been a long time coming. The last exhibition game was a scoreless tie in Ottawa, and now tonight, third period, before they could get one. They had enough chances, though, to score in the first period, really. Some real good chances. But Brodeur was solid. Osa nearly got in close. Off the glass and down the ice. Icing is going to be a call.
Well, Seaback gets his first goal of this tournament.
Bartechko gets one assist, Radivojevic the other.
Let's have a look at it. Canada had possession of the puck and they never got it back. And here we're showing you, Seaback came out of the corner and took the pass and made no mistake on an easy goal.
Littner tried to get one through. Dimitra was in there. There is Orzog bringing it off the boards and coming out front of the net. Knocked down by Dimitra, fanned on the shot. In around the net. Niedermayer had his man tied up. Vladimir Orzog on it again and made short, stayed in. Gavrik lost it and it's flipped to center. A two-on-one shaping up. Back to Brewer coming in and the shot is on. Stana made a nice save by just standing there and waiting for Brewer to drive it at him.
Well, Brewer jumped into the rush as the late man, and they're often hard to pick up on the defensive coverage. And he looked like a forward till there, and then he looked like a defenseman. He'd like to have that over again, I'm sure. However, give him credit. He knew enough to jump into the rush and get in good position.
4-1, Canada leads in Slovakia. Seaback, the goal scorer, moving the puck out of the zone. Team Canada has it. Radivojevic forechecking. Up high, down the ice it goes. Again, moving up with Lemieux right behind him. Lemieux takes the puck in. Had it knocked away by Bartechko. Lemieux has it again with Aginla on the boards, the two of them. Aginla didn't see it and the skates at the line, and Hannon made a good move to keep it in. It'll be cleared down to center ice. Foot back. Turning was Scott Hannon. He got center all right and then pounded the puck in deep. Upsuit back there for Slovakia, lost it. The Cavalier was in front, it gets to the line where the shot comes and blocked. And Slovakia get out of the zone again. Radivojevic coming in off the boards on this near side. Went in too far and the pass hit a skate. After it, Nagy. He stopped. Canada will clear the puck. They're up 4-1. A break coming in. Off the goalpost, Smith scores on the rebound. Right to Smith. He was going to the net and Heatley there too.
Well, Le Cavalier took the shot that had Stana beaten, but it hit the post and came right to Smith, who was the other forward on the two-on-one rush. No chance for the goalie at all, and Ryan Smith gets his second of the night. Here's the shot off the post, and Smith jumps on the rebound, and the goaltender was in no shape to make the save. He was concentrating on Le Cavalier's shot and couldn't get over in time to stop Smith. Canada makes it 5-1 on the Smith goal, his second of the night.
If Smith didn't drive it home, it would have been Heatley. He was right behind him. The two of them headed for the net as the Cavalier ripped it to hit the post. Everybody heard it. Smith gets his second goal of the game to make it 5-1 Canada. Very impressive win tonight by Team Canada after the close one last night against the USA, 2-1. There's Dome. He's had another strong game for the Canadians. Shot around the boards. Will it get out? Yes, it'll be Josef Stumpel who flipped it up the center and gets the return pass coming in. Stumpel's pass, though, the second time was intercepted. Now the puck off the side of the net. Stumpel has it by Chara on this near side. Hossa lost it. Three Canadians are coming out, led by Richards to center. Doan to his right, coming to the net. Richards keeps going, and he's been checked by Vishnovsky. Canada, though, Gagne stopped that clearing attempt. Now it's shot down the ice. Dimitra nearly got a break. Had he picked that one up? Just missed it. Adam Foote clears the zone. San Luis moving up. Let the puck clip in over the line and then hope to get it open to somebody. But Vishnovsky was there. Dangerous pass. Got by everybody, though. Two Canadians missed that at the Slovak line. Now Richards. Hard working there to move it out to Gagne. Down to San Luis with Gagne coming in. San Luis will take it again, lifted high into Gagne. There's Richards. He missed that. But there at the blue line, it's kept in. Shot deep by Hannon. Round the net. 5-1 your score as we come up to the halfway mark of the third period. And that's Gabarek. He left it at the line. The defenseman, Ludomir Vishnovsky, couldn't get a shot. Dimitra behind the net. A stop by Niedermeyer. He rolled it ahead and Canada got it out. Might have had a 2-on-1 had that pass clicked at the blue line to San Luis. But it was way by him. Vishnovsky back up with it. Had to turn back. Forechecking was sacked. And there's Lemieux getting the puck. Losing it, though, just outside the line. And Slovakia will move it up. They got it in deep. But Brodeur out to play. Right onto the stick, however, of Bartechko. He got an assist on the only goal scored by Slovakia. Seabach got that. Long shot tipped away. Seabach after the rebound. Won't happen. Cleared out by Canada. Halfway mark. We've just hit it. And it's 5-1 Canada. Stopped at the line. Seabach again looking for a chance. Moving up. Gets in deep and around the net. Skating well. All the way back out to Suchi. Veered in around the net again. Then Radivojevic picks it up. He's forced to skate back. Miles. Canada playing well in there now. Everybody covered, so it's easy to move it out to the center ice area. Smith striding up, gets it. Good work by Smith to drop it to the Cavalier. Backed it up. The pass intercepted just in time. And cleared out to center ice. Again, Heatley finds Smith. Winding up the shot off a stick and up high off the glass. Stumpel gets the puck ahead for Slovakia. Down to center. Hossa didn't get anywhere. Fired in there with 9 minutes left in the third. Now they start to pick up the pace of it. Lead pass is good. Draper. Rebound. And cleared out of the zone. Draper had the Jets going. Hossa tried to flip it out the net. As they open it up here. Big rebound went by Hossa in front. Three Canadians down to center on this rush. Dome. Decides to try to fool Chara, but no dice. Chara stayed with him. But he gets the puck out to Draper, back into Doan. Doan set again. Draper flipped it in there. They're all around the Slovakians now. That is Thornton trying to come out. Thornton gets the pass away, and it's back out over the line. Cannon just a little late getting to it. By Draper, tipped in. That's the sign to change him up. 5-1, 8 minutes left, third. Slovakia stung early by Thornton and Smith in the first period. Brodeur, another glove save. Gagne with Richards. Gagne flipped it out in front of the net. San Luis was there, and he has to skate away with it to the side. Brewer and Regier. That one shot in wide. Gavrik didn't see it. Kept him along the boards. That is San Luis trying to pick it up. And Slovakia gets the puck down the ice. Canada looking sharper. Five goals tonight. 2-1 last night over the USA, and we're leading 5-1 here against Slovakia.
Samsung introduces another breakthrough in DLP design. The award-winning pedestal TV with DLP. Style meets performance.
All across the country, people are signing up for the new CIBC Unlimited checking account.
I signed up.
There you go, because they're tired of getting dinged with unexpected service charges.
No kidding.
Right, so now every transaction, withdrawal, bill.
Every debit, check.
All covered with one flat monthly fee.
But just online, right?
Everywhere. At the branch, their bank machine.
On the phone.
At the store. It's all covered. It's a CIBC Unlimited checking account.
Hey, did you say unlimited checking?
Yeah, no, not that kind of checking.
Introducing the new CIBC Unlimited checking account. No limits, no surprises.
Get us some snacks.
Okay. Two hot dogs, please. Two hot dogs!
Peanuts! Get your peanuts!
You drink it all?
The next game for Slovakia is Friday night when they play the USA in St. Paul. We'll have that one for you. And Canada plays Russia Saturday night in Toronto. And, of course, we'll have that one for you, too.
That is the next big test for Canada against Russia on Saturday night on the CBC network.
Tomorrow night from St. Paul.
Watch out!
We'll have the U.S.-Russia game. Well, Canada started quickly, and they didn't fade like they did last night against the United States. A little bit in the first period, but since then it's been pretty well all Canada.
Hard hit by Kartechko. Foot shakes it off. Puck is in deep. Center. Sacking. And Aginla was in on the rebound again, but upended. Kara takes it behind the net out of harm's way and then flipped it ahead too high over the glass. This presentation of the World Cup of Hockey on CBC continues in a moment.
Entertainment for the bus ride to the Stouffville Clippers away game, $140. One bag of Cheesies, Tim Hortons donuts, Smarties, and pop, $42. Motel rooms for the night, $240.
Knowing there's a big clean sheet of ice waiting on the other end, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard, hockey fan and sponsor of the World Cup of Hockey.
Introducing a new way to make tea using a time-honored tradition, loose tea leaves. The secret to great-tasting tea is allowing the water to surround the tea leaves, coaxing out every last drop of flavor. So, Tim Hortons had a third-generation tea master design the ideal tea steeper, which gently steeps the tea. Ah, for a perfect pot, every time. Tim Hortons' new steep tea. Great-tasting tea, every time.
Always fresh at Tim Hortons.
The wait is over. It's Kia's Drive More Clear Out, our biggest sales event of the year with unbeatable deals on great vehicles. Get 0% purchase financing plus up to $2,000 cash back, or choose great low lease rates. All backed by Canada's best ownership coverage, including free oil changes for life.
These deals won't last, so hurry into your local Kia dealer today.
Welcome back to the Bell Center in Montreal. 6:37 remaining in the third period. Canada on top of Slovakia quite comfortably, 5-1. 2-0 after the first. Gagne added a third in the second. St. Louis and Smith second here in the third. Seebach has scored the goal for Slovakia. Bartechko assisted and got the puck out of the zone. Seebach missed it though. It's back in. Opsuit turned it back up ice. Radivojevic flipped it up across the line. And Niedermeyer was back. Over there, Heatley. Took it on a skate, lost a chance to move it out. Regier did it for him. Off the glass. Bartechko is back and chased off the puck. Tapped loose for Le Cavalier. Good work by Smith again on that forecheck. Radivojevic lost it to Smith. And again he's up with Le Cavalier, but they decide to turn and get off on a change. Under 6 minutes left.
And the fans here in Montreal should be complimented. They have really inspired the Canadiens to two wins. Loud, many of them dressed in Team Canada uniforms. And they've enjoyed both these games as we have.
Could be the last game here at the Bell Center for some time. And they are enjoying this.
A new stick for Matthew Renzoni, $22. New pads for Jeffrey Garbig, $92. A new mouth guard for Josh Burkholder, $15. A new hockey season for the Scoville Clippers, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard, hockey fan and sponsor of the World Cup of Hockey.
Samsung introduces another breakthrough in DLP design. The award-winning pedestal TV with DLP. Style meets performance.
Do you have the right truck?
North America's best-selling half-ton regular. And extended cab. Is now available as a crew cab. It's got more standard horsepower, more torque, and more towing capacity than Ford or Dodge half-ton crews. Introducing the new Silverado half-ton crew. It's the right truck from Chevy.
Brian Burke's old boss, Sandra Quinn, between those two ladies, enjoying her husband's victory here tonight.
Raper will have to take this face off, caught and thrown off. Sturbeck started the play out for Slovakia, and he'll take it again. Return the pass. That was not expected. Nobody could move on it that quickly. And Vishnovsky has to come back now in his own zone and turns with Stumpel. He comes out, trying to hook it up, and that's stopped. Thornton in there and in front of the net. The pass, shot. Rebound was there. Draper had another chance, bounced away from him. Doan had the first chance, and there's Draper again with Brewer playing it in for Thornton behind the goal. Centered it. Hit a skate of Sturbeck. Stay behind that line. Glove now, Astana. And he holds.
Well, Joe Thornton certainly has come a long way since that first exhibition game. Some guys take a little longer to get in the groove than others, but he looks like the Joe Thornton we've seen so often for the Boston Bruins. He took a bad rap by not producing in the playoffs. He was frozen up for every game and not at all healthy.
And never complained one time.
Not at all.
Scored a 3:02 in the first period in this game and really got him going. They got another goal from Smith, his first of two. Then Gagne in the second period. Seebach scored the only goal for Slovakia up to this point. St. Louis and Smith second. The other scorers, they're in there again. San Luis centering it. Aguirre had to step up off the line to make sure it stays in, and Gagne filled his role back to the point. Over there is Suzuki. Got it ahead, not out, and flipped in behind the net for him. Takes his time and comes away with Canada changing. He had lots of time to move it. Open ice. Gaborik, no room to move. Dumped in by Lemieux. He comes in forechecking. With him is Sakic. On the puck around the net, Joe Sakic looking out. Stops. Plays it back. Mario centers. Again, Lance Sakic on the puck in there. With great energy. Lemieux shoots it. Hit a skate. Comes right back out to the line. Cannon fires it in around the net. That is again lost. Joe Sakic there with him. But it'll be cleared out off the glass. 3:25 left to play in the third.
Mario, the fans are yelling. Everyone happy to see him back in a hockey uniform playing.
He's from Montreal and he has the puck. They love him. They get a goal. Boy, saluting him right here. Mario's on the puck in there. Sensing something might happen. Not this shift, though. He's headed off now. And he gets a hand. 3 minutes left in the third. He's a scratch golfer, and I said to him yesterday, I guess with the weight you've lost and the shape you're in, you're hitting the ball another 20 yards. And he walked away and he turned and he said, no, about 15.
Well, he is in great shape. 215 pounds. I know I've said this before. He played a lot of hockey in this league and had great success when he was 230 to 240. Jake Caulfield, his former teammate, is his fitness director in Pittsburgh. So he's got his fingerprints over the new Lemieux.
2:50 left. Hossa shot the puck in. Chetan up there hoping to pick it up. Didn't do it. Canada gets it out. Knocked down again by Thornton. However, he was checked by Vishnovsky in time to move it. Stumple. Hossa cuts in on the backhand now. Put the brakes on. Vishnovsky shoots. Nice pass saved by Brodeur. Hossa keeps it in for him. Hossa again takes it. He shot the puck at the crowd in front of the net. And it's cleared out to center ice. 2:10 remaining. Stumple bodied by Brewer. Chetan trying to pass. And another. Brodeur knifed that away from the danger area. And Canada clears the puck under 2 minutes. No icing. They're all changing. Great crowd, as you mentioned. And they're starting to sing again. They've had a ball here in the first two games of this World Cup tournament here in the North American pool. Canada and the States last night. What a great start. And they won it 2-1. Exciting hockey game. Minute and a half left in this, the second for Canada. The first for Slovakia. And Canada is going to go up 2 straight victories.
Well, they have been clearly the best team tonight. Slovaks came back in the last half of the first period and looked like they might make a game of it, but that third goal really put them in a hole that was too deep to climb out of. And Canada will leave for Toronto, where they play Saturday against the Russians.
.125 left. The bet is that Mario will get one more shift for this crowd. Here's Heatley centering it. Beautiful play and a great save by Stanna. Heatley made that great pass, but Smith couldn't beat him. He has twice tonight. This little backhander is wide at the Canadian goal. Final minutes. And a penalty coming.
It's going to go to Team Canada. In front of the net, it looks like it's
Niedermeyer. Or is it? Wait a minute.
I think it might be Gagne. Cannon,
no,
sorry.
Defensive.
He was tangled up with the Slovak player in front of the net. The opinion of the referee, it's a roughing call. There it is right there. Orsog is the victim, and you can see Hannon had a stick up onto the side of the head of Orsog. Slovakia comes back to pick it up. Only 45 seconds remaining. The penalty to Hannon, negating a chance for Lemieux to come on with his line mates, Aginla and Joel Sakic. 30 seconds left. Slovakia pass it around, look for something positive, maybe one more goal. Radivojevic gets it to the blue line. Littner returns it to him. Chara waiting, shoots it in there to the corner. Centered again, and Canada doesn't clear it right away. Bartechko doesn't handle it cleanly. Radivojevic is stopped. Joe Sakic stopped him. Chara gets ready. The crowd roaring. That's it. Cleared out. And Canada is going to win this one with a 5-1 score as Stena takes the last shot hip high. Well, Canada will cinch first place in this tournament unless Russia, who haven't played a game yet, win all three of their games, including the Saturday night game against Canada. And this will ensure that Team Canada will play the first playoff game in Toronto from the home crowd.
35 shots for Canada, 25 for Slovakia. 14-8 margin in the third period. Two goals by Ryan Smith, spearheading the attack. Thornton, Gagne, and San Luis, the others. Seaback got the only goal for Slovakia. Rodur was solid again tonight. Great in the early going. They will announce now the most valuable player or the outstanding player for each team. It'll be the man we just talked about, Martin Brodeur for Canada. What a great solid start. And continued that solid goaltending all night. Marian Gaborik, the outstanding player for Slovakia. The Team Canada was just too much for this team tonight. They won their first last night over the USA 2-1, tonight over Slovakia by a score of 5-1.
World Cup of Hockey on CBC, brought to you by CIBC. CIBC, for what matters. And by Tim Hortons. Go Canada, go.
That's what I'm talking about!
Anacondas. Now playing in theaters everywhere.
Introducing a new way to make tea using a time-honored tradition. Loose tea leaves. The secret to great-tasting tea is allowing the water to surround the tea leaves, coaxing out every last drop of flavor. So, Tim Hortons had a third-generation tea master design the ideal tea steeper, which gently steeps the tea. For a perfect pot, every time. Tim Hortons' new steep tea. Great-tasting tea, every time.
Only special Tim Hortons.
There's something in here! That's what I'm talking about!
Anacondas. Now playing in theaters everywhere.
If you ever come, better give me what I want. I'm addicted. It's growing strong. It's growing strong again. The consequences.
How to get 2 huge liters of Baskin-Robbins ice cream from our freezer to yours. First, make one of those periscopes so you can see where you're going. Walk slowly, breathe deeply. Upon arrival, Clean out the freezer, bend at the knees, and clean and jerk each one into place. Next, get some police tape. Rope off the area in case of poachers. 2 liters of Baskin-Robbins ice cream, your choice of 10 flavors for a measly $10. Now get 2 free play all day passes to Ontario Place with your 2-for-10 purchase. Keep moving, kid. Nothing to see here.
Now there's a way to make your home phone mobile. City Fido, with unlimited local calling in the Greater Toronto Area for just $45 per month. Regrettably, only from Fido.
Boy, Pat Quinn and the coaching staff have to be pleased with 2 games this early in the year that were as terrific as that for their side. Martin Brodeur, funny to name him the number one star in a 5-1 romp, but critical saves in the first period and just throughout the game, great leadership. Ryan Smith, Marty St. Louis, you could say Marian Gabrick was obviously MVP for the Slovaks in the game, might have been on the other side of the ledger, but this was clearly Canada's romp, so we give them the 3 stars. Ryan, we may be cutting in to get to Mario Lemieux and some other reaction from the dressing rooms, but first blush, your thoughts.
Well, I like the fact that Canada put all those goals up on the board and the blue-collar effort in the third period. I felt it was exemplary last night the way Canada played and protected their lead, and I think they did that again tonight. They didn't sag after the goal. They kept grinding, working. Real blue-collar effort in the third period.
You were saying that they'll accept the roles if they're great talents, as long as they know there's something big at stake, and we'll just get to that. Here's Marty Brodeur. Marty, go ahead, Scott.
All right, Ron, thanks very much. Yeah, here's Marty Brodeur. What did you think of your night's work?
Well, a little busy, but it was fine. I thought we played an excellent game. You know, they had a few chances early in the game, but we settled down. We had a lot of chances, I think, so it was kind of a tough game for us. We wanted to make sure we played well defensively because their skill offensively that they have, and I thought we did most of the night. You know, they couldn't get to any rebounds and stuff like that, and that was good. And, you know, 5 goals, first time since we've all together we were able to score that.
Well, let's talk about your performance specifically. You seem to be on top of your game, and I think a lot of people would say that you broke the backs of the opposition tonight. Would you agree?
Well, you know, I think when they got their chances, I was able to make key saves. But that's just part of what I do. You know, it's important that everybody chips in. Sometimes you don't get the 30, 40 shots tonight, but I think the chances depends where they are in the game. I was able to make some good saves.
Home ice advantage can sometimes be overrated, but I'm not so sure that would be the case with the crowd here at the Bell Center.
Well, there's a lot of pressure. I think everybody expects us to do well, and definitely this crowd was amazing. You know, I come here usually with the Devils, and they're not cheering too much for us, so it's kind of nice to be on the other side of the medal here, and we're definitely appreciative of the crowd in Montreal so far.
Doesn't seem to be much chance that you won't go the distance for Team Canada if you keep playing the way you did tonight. Do you feel like you're the number one goaltender?
Well, you know, they put me in for the first 2 games, and definitely, you know, I'm going to go day by day like I do always. I think it's nice to play these games, but it's all to preparation to that big game, and that's the game in the quarterfinal that there'll be no tomorrow. So hopefully I'll be able to play that game and get myself into the perfect condition for me to excel in the big games.
Thanks, Marty.
Thank you.
Ron, back to you.
What were you just saying, Brian?
I think Marty could play 2 more periods tonight, and the guy's capacity for work and his capacity to make a big save after a prolonged period of inactivity is amazing to me. The New Jersey system makes him play for long stretches without a serious scoring opportunity. Most goaltenders have a problem coming up big after that, and he does it all the time.
That's the thing that impresses me the most, how he can do that, and also only face 20 shots in a game. And a lot of times you don't think of him as being the biggest outcome or the biggest factor in the outcome, but he is. Just for that ability, he had that chance in the second period again. Chetan, a terrific shot, and Brodeur was about 4 or 5 minutes without action before that and simply made a great glove save. And then in the commercial break, what I really found interesting, his focus. They had a 3-0 lead at that time, and he didn't let his guard down whatsoever.
Go ahead, Tim.
Yeah, we have that. And it was just such an incredible save. Well, this is different.
This is his rebound control. This is twice. He makes unbelievable saves, but he kicks the puck right to a teammate. It's not only stopping the puck, but it's an outlet pass.
There's the shot right there. And that's incredible focus to go that long. And again, here's in the commercial break. And as an ex-goaltender, I'm really impressed with that because he just absolutely never lets his mind think about anything else.
Now, are you telling me he could go another two games?
Two periods, no problem.
Yes.
Well, this is early for a goalie, and you always look to see how a goalie is in the third period of games at this time of the year, because that's definitely when they're going to sag, if they're going to sag.
And you compare his puck handling ability all night long. Team Canada dumped the puck in. The puck goes around, and there's a puck battle. And more often than not, Team Canada came up with a puck. Marty stops every puck, makes a smart pass to his defenseman or an outlet pass. To be able to make a kick save like that and direct it right onto a teammate's stick, it's unbelievable.
And this is what I found in this game that Marty did so much better than Stana. Stana has to learn, if he's going to be an NHL goaltender, he has to come out more often. Not all the time. A lot of times the puck was rimmed around high on the glass. And, yeah, leave those for your defenseman. But when it's shot around the bottom of the boards, you have to get out there and help your defenseman.
That'll be a big change in the American Hockey League this year, though. That's where they're going to have the goaltender has to play it, and he can't, from a certain spot behind the net, shoot the puck. He can stop it.
Right.
But he can't advance it, so we'll have to watch for that. Elliot Friedman and Marian Hossa. Here's some post-game reaction from the Slovaks to their debut in this year's World Cup.
Thank you, Ron. Marian, Peter Stastny was on in the second intermission. He said, first period, you guys, he thought, played Canada pretty even. Where did it go badly from there?
Well, you know, they score quick two goals, and they got late in the home building. It's tough to come back against a team like that. But we tried to come back in the first period. I think we played solid. But after that, they just keep playing good, you know, and we couldn't catch up.
You know, you mentioned that point about Canada here. Now we've seen two nights in a row Canada come out with a super energized building and really put the other team in trouble. You and Russia don't get a chance to play a home game in this tournament. Is that a big disadvantage for you guys?
Well, it's tough to say, you know. I wouldn't say, you know, I don't want to use it as an excuse, but we just have to come up next game more stronger than we did tonight.
And just thank you very much, Mary.
Thank you.
Ron?
All right, Elliot, there's the fan celebration going on here still at the Bell Center, 5-1 the final. By the way, Wade Redden, we're getting a report, upper body injury. He will be re-examined tomorrow. Wade Redden, upper body injury is why he left in the second period. Let's go back to Scott Oak now with Mario Lemieux.
Mario, how did it feel going back to back?
Felt great. Actually, I felt better tonight. I was seeing the ice a little bit better. My skating was better, especially with the puck and seeing the ice well. So I'm glad I decided to come back tonight and be a part of it.
It sounds like you didn't give it any consideration to not play tonight.
No, I was off for about 10, 11 months, so I've had plenty of rest. And I have to play a little bit more and get a feel for the speed that we have here in the World Cup. And I felt a lot better tonight.
And Mario, the Salt Lake City team warmed to the cause, I guess, more slowly than this one. Is this one starting off at a higher level?
I think so. I think that, you know, it's kind of a different team that we have. We had a lot of veterans in 2002, and here we have some younger guys that have not competed at this level for a while. But I like the makeup of the team. I think from defense to offense, we're the best goalie in the world. I think we're in good shape.
The crowd here has been outstanding. I can't imagine that it has not been a factor for you. What's your assessment been of it?
Yeah, it's always a huge factor for us playing in Canada, and especially here in Montreal. This is great fans that we have here in Montreal. I grew up here, and it's been like this as far as I can remember. So I'm sure it's going to be the same way in Toronto. Great hockey town in Toronto. I'm looking forward to playing there as well.
And they seem to be acknowledging that this may be the last time they see you play for a while. They were chanting Mario, yeah. Mario at the end. What did you think of that?
I think it's great. Every time I play in this building, people support what I'm trying to do out there, and it's always been great. Every time I've played here with Pittsburgh, they've always been great to me.
What do you do for the 2 days off now?
I'm not sure what the schedule is tomorrow. Probably going to practice in the afternoon and then relax tomorrow night and get ready for Saturday.
Thanks, Mario.
All right, my pleasure.
Ron, back to you.
Thanks a lot, Scott. You don't even know where to begin with Mario Lemieux, what to praise him for the most. But that line, when you look at Sakic, who I think is the heir apparent, it might have been Stevie Y, but it looks like Sakic would be the other guy that really runs that room. Would you agree with that?
Well, Joe's a very quiet guy. His leadership comes more in what he does rather than he says, much like Mario.
Yeah.
But this goes back to the point we were talking about earlier about the role that players can play. If players are good enough players, and Canada has always had success playing the best players they can put on the team, great players will accept a different role. And this is a great example. We'll see what Mario does later in the show here with his hitting. But if you notice, players that are superstars on their team in tournaments like this are asked to play bottom six forward roles, checking roles, and Canada has had success when their players have done that well.
Well, and also, the great players always adjust their game, and they're willing to adapt. And I'm thinking of Mario and his defensive play now. He used to be weak like a lot of young offensive players. He's really strong defensively now, a lot like a guy like Joe Sakic, Mike Modano, great in his own zone. Brendan Morrison, who you had in Vancouver, he's terrific defensively. And I think that's why Mario is such a great player at this age in this tournament, because he never hurts in his own zone.
Well, certainly last night when he went after Connor Walchuk after he took on Brodeur, and then here's tonight the key shift you were talking about, Brian, and it's not just the three hits on this shift, but also his defensive position you were both noticing.
Well, there's a good bang on the forecheck. He continues his puck battle. Team loses the puck. He goes back down, stays in his coverage assignment, goes down low, throws another hit, stays on the net side of the player, so he's in the right position defensively. And it hits him again. He's still on the net side, so he's on the right side. I mean, that's what you want defensive players to do, and he's the best offensive player, second best to ever play the game.
And over time, I think Le Cavalier will learn that as well, because he's still a little bit young, and usually it takes a little bit of time to add that part of his game, but he's learning.
It was a great shot of Adam Foote teaching Eric Brewer, and
yeah.
Brewer looked a little gassed at that point in the third period, but, you know, that's what... Obviously, it had to happen for Mario in 87 when Wayne showed him. This is the first goal of the game tonight. Joe Thornton, and he's really come on like gangbusters after a so-called slow start in the camp. But this is Iginla and Sakic playing together, and they had Gagne on the wing. And Gagne was also impressive to me.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't find a Canadian that didn't look well. But here's the Thornton goal, Brian.
Well, I didn't. I noticed this pick late. If you watch the play here, you're going to see the play right here. Here's the theft. And there's the bump by Jerome Iginla. And Jerome, I don't know why I'm going out of my way to compliment you after the large role you played in my dismissal, but I wanted to make sure everyone in Canada noticed that goal probably doesn't happen without Jerome making a smart play. And not enough of a pick to be a penalty. Like, that wasn't a missed call. That was an acceptable pick.
He was a presence all night, and that one feed by Mario, he's had, as Bob Cole said, five quality scoring chances. Jerome's historically a slow starter, so it's going to take him probably a game or two.
He'll score soon with those chances. That one chance he had in the second period that Stanna made a stumbling save on, that's going in soon.
And he's doing everything else right. This is a guy with no holes in his game. He's physical.
Yeah.
He's active on the forecheck. He's forcing turnovers. I'm impressed with him, and I always am.
Here's Simon Gagné's unbelievable eye-hand coordination, and I thought maybe Rostislav Stanna had blown this goal, but no chance.
No, I was almost shocked, actually, that Gagné was able to get his hands on the play here, because I believe it's Chara that almost intercepts this pass, and for Gagné to make the adjustment and get his hands on the other side and then flip the puck over Stanna's pad, that's really a remarkable play, and one you don't see that often. I thought Stanna got over perfectly. He had his leg down right by the post. He had about a foot there, and Gagne to get it up about 15 inches, that's very difficult.
If you're Pat Quinn, what are you worried about? And this goes back to the discussion we had going into the tournament. These games, you said, would be meaningful, obviously, to get your intensity up, and it's worked.
Right.
You're bang on. You're going to have 2 days off, face the Russians. That game, Russia could take them for first place, which would just mean Canada would likely play the United States.
I'm not worried about a thing.
Nothing?
If I'm Pat Quinn, no way.
Yeah.
This is perfect. Everybody's playing really well.
Well, you got Redden and Jovanovski. That's the only
injuries,
thing you're starting to worry about, injuries. If you had all let up, but I can't see why they would. Yeah, let's eavesdrop a little bit on Pat Quinn, met with the media. Let's go to Pat at the rostrum. I think he addresses the Wade Redden injury, and perhaps we'll get a little more from Pat Quinn earlier.
Yeah, we don't know how severe again. He was hurt right at the end of the first period, rather, and we'll know further tomorrow how serious. Up top, yeah.
Coach, last night I thought Ryan Smith was noticeable for his physical play in a very physical game. Tonight was more of a skill game, and Ryan showed off the skills. Can you talk about what kind of a hockey player Ryan Smith is?
Yeah, I didn't catch the end of the...
In a physical game. Tonight was more of a skill game, and he showed his skills. Can you talk about what kind of a versatile hockey player Ryan Smith is?
Yeah. That's why he is so valuable to his team. He's and has been for Canadian teams. He's played a number of times that he can play the type of game that allows him to play just about any way you have to play. Some nights, like for example against the Americans, it was physical, and he can respond. He can play that way. He'll go into tough areas, and he'll also make you pay if you come in the tough areas. What he also does with the Vinny and Danny, who are pretty high-skilled guys, he fits in real well. And what he does too, he still uses that ability to get to the puck to help them, even though it is a skilled situation. He makes room for the skilled guys with his pursuit and with his determination, and I think that helps him. And he has good enough hands. You saw him pot one tonight, and you know, he just fit in pretty well there.
Pat Quinn earlier, Ken Hitchcock joins us now. Where are you, Ken?
I'm just outside the locker room, guys. Hello.
Yeah, it's nice of you to join us. Thanks for that. First of all, your comments on the game tonight.
Well, I thought second game back-to-back with all the energy in the building yesterday, I thought the fans and the team responded in the right way. We played a really sound hockey game. We did a lot of things really well tonight. Again, in the third period with the lead, we played the right way, shift after shift, and we were able to extend it. I think there was a as impressive as yesterday's game was, today for me was probably even a little bit better because you expect a little bit of a drop in energy, and we didn't have it at all.
Are you a little bit surprised, though, that the team is at this level so quickly?
To be honest with you, no. Not the way this team is in the prime of a lot of their careers, and they are eager to compete, eager to learn. It's a real fun group to be around as a coach because they're all ears, they're all eyes, and they just want to go out and play hockey. And you know, it's a unique situation for us as coaches to be involved with so many players who are right in that zone career-wise, and you can see them almost getting better, especially guys like LeCavalier and Heatley, Gagne, Richards, St. Louis. You can see these kids getting better shift in and shift out, and it's a, like I said, a fun group to be around right now.
Hitch, the defense, you started without a couple of really quality defensemen. You've lost at least one. We're not sure about Wade Redden. You're confident that you have the depth that if Redden can't go, you're going to be in good shape?
I don't think there's any problem there. I think Jay Bouwmeester at times was one of our top two or three defensemen in camp, and he's played enough hockey in the National Hockey League. He's a big guy, skates really well, and he's got terrific vision at moving the puck. So, you know, if Wade has to miss a little bit of time here, I see no reason that Jay can't come in and do a great job. And you know, we've got lots of time between games now, so we got time to rest people and everything. And you know, you're playing a game every third day as this thing moves along. So we've got lots left.
Hitch, have you been following the other pool in Europe? I'm sure someone on the coaching staff's been watching that with interest. What did you think of the game this afternoon?
Well, I thought the Swedes hit the wall a little bit, and then the Czechs really started to play. And you know, two things stick out to me. First of all, so the Swedes and Finns are playing the best hockey right now. But the comments by the Czech players, to me, really, I feel like they're sitting in the weeds. I think they're waiting to win a hockey game, and I think they're hoping that they can pick their spots and win the right game. I think we saw a little bit of a flash in the third period, and if they get the roster loaded up and ready, they could be dangerous. But from a team play standpoint, it's the Finns and the Swedes that are playing the best.
I've always thought, Ken, two things always factor in: goaltending wins, and if two teams give 100%, talent wins. And Canadians have always had one other little ingredient, maybe the Americans too, and that's emotion. So if they're going to try and play possum, I don't think you can do that anymore. I think there was a time when you could play possum as the Russians and Czechs coming over here. But what you said about the leadership in your room, and especially from the kids, that Richards is uncanny. He reminds me so much of Sakic, who reminds me of Yzerman, and I guess they all get it from Mario and Wayne. I'd like your thoughts on whether anybody can catch the Canadians off guard.
Well,
of course you're going to say not, but why you might think that wouldn't happen?
I think, Ron, because we're not afraid to win. I think we enjoy the challenge. I don't think you're going to see this team come out and play nervous ever. You know, if we get beat sometime down the road, that those things happen in sport. They happen in our game, but we're not afraid to win, and we're not afraid to play to win. You're not going to see our team come out and play cautious and nervous at all. We want to play. We want to get on the ice. This group of players wants to get on the ice and practice. They want to be together.
Although it was a turning point, wasn't it, in the second period the other night when Garen Tkachuk started to rough it up a little bit, and there was a shock goal. It was just a, you know, it looked like it was entirely your game, and then there was a goal, and for about 4 minutes, that to me was going to be the litmus test of maybe the youth in your team, especially in your own end. What did you think of that?
I thought the third period was a litmus test. I thought that we proved in the third period that we know how to play with the lead. It was a 2-1 lead, and we played a very mature period. And I think if there was an opportunity for us to be nervous and panic, that was the time, and we didn't do it. And hopefully we can build on it. We seem to build on it today from that third period yesterday, and hopefully we can continue to get better. Look, we're going to have to play better than we've played even in these first two games if we expect to be there at the end. But we're capable of it. And our players, I think that's the reason our players are so excited about our opportunity. We think we have a chance to be a special group here, and we want to take advantage of it.
What do you expect from the Russians, and will you have to change anything?
Well, I think I don't think there's a team in this side that can play the way the Russians can play. And I think if you do play that way, like the Americans did that in the second and third period of that exhibition game, you're going to lose. They got too much one-on-one skill, too much talent. We have to play our way. We have to play a very simple puck pursuit game. We have to make it uncomfortable for them in critical areas, especially the front of their own net. I think we have to be looking at second and third shot opportunities all night. If we do those things and we don't get sucked into the one-on-one game, I think we'll do fine.
Who stood out for you tonight? It was a team effort, but was there any individual performances that really caught your eye?
Well, I think Joe Thornton's really coming on like gangbusters. I think Joe's really starting to play well. You can't help but love the way that Doan and Aginla play. But for me, the line from a technical standpoint that's doing a lot of things right is Richard's line. They're playing well as a group. They're creating turnovers because of their strong positioning. And I love watching that line play hockey. Like I said, we're getting a lot of great performances by everybody, but some of these younger guys are really stepping up.
There's no doubt about that. Yeah. Hey, Ken, thanks for your time. We'll have lots of time as we move along in the tournament, but I'm sure it's fun for you with Jacques and Pat and all the old gang back together again. Continued success.
Thanks a lot.
Ken Hitchcock, head coach of it. Well, not head coach. Pat will be mad at me for that, but on the staff, of course, for Team Canada as they celebrate a 5-1 victory versus Slovakia. Back with more of our World Cup coverage in a moment.
Entertainment for the bus ride to the Stouffville Clippers away game. $140. One bag of Cheesies, Tim Hortons Donuts, Smarties, and Pop, $42. Motel rooms for the night, $240.
Knowing there's a big clean sheet of ice waiting on the other end, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard, hockey fan and sponsor of the World Cup of Hockey.
The wait is over. It's Kia's Drive More Clear Out, our biggest sales event of the year with unbeatable deals on great vehicles. Get 0% purchase financing plus up to $2,000 cash back, or choose great low lease rates. All backed by Canada's best ownership coverage, including free oil changes for life. These deals won't last, so hurry into your local Kia dealer today.
When the Coors Light Brewing Company puts its mind to something, we follow through. You said you wanted a beer that would be ice cold. Done. You said you wanted a beer with an easy drinking taste. So be it. You said you wanted to meet those girls over there.
You can do that?
Hey, we make beer, not miracles. Coors Light, the silver bullet.
Hello?
Can you hear me? Please help! They're going to kill me!
Who is this, Chloe?
Someone I'm talking to is destroyed. If you hang up, I mean, I'd be able to get anybody else. No!
Oh, God.
Kim Basinger, Chris Evans, Jason Statham, and William H. Macy. Cellular.
In theaters, Friday, September 10th.
How to get 2 huge liters of Baskin-Robbins ice cream from our freezer to yours. First, make one of those periscopes so you can see where you're going. Walk slowly, breathe deeply. Upon arrival, clean out the freezer, bend at the knees, and clean and jerk each one into place. Next, get some police tape. Rope off the area in case of poachers. 2 liters of Baskin-Robbins ice cream, your choice of 10 flavors for a measly $10. Now get 2 free play all day passes to Ontario Place with your 2-for-10 purchase. Keep moving, kid. Nothing to see here.
Looking for the hottest deals in town? Come into Leon's today and enjoy all our hot, hot power buys. And extra special this week only, every single sofa is on sale. All modern, all traditional, all leather, and you pay absolutely nothing, not even the taxes, for 15 months OAC. But hurry, it all ends this weekend.
Internationally recognized for outstanding investigative journalism. A new season of stories that must be told. The Fifth Estate returns this fall, Wednesday, October 6th on CBC Television.
We'll get back to the hockey game in a moment, but first a quick look at some of the stories coming up on tonight's National. Starting in southern Russia, where more than 100 children are being held hostage. Special forces have surrounded the scene, but the people inside have warned they'll blow up the school if the troops attack. The hostage takers are thought to be connected to the rebel forces in nearby Chechnya. In Florida, people are bracing for another big hurricane. Hundreds of thousands of people in the Palm Beach area have been warned to be ready to flee to safer ground. And a lot of people are still talking about those jerseys.
I thought it was strange. The yellow, black, now.
We'll get the reviews and the story behind those colors. Those stories and more are coming up on the National.
Joel Thornton with his first. Ryan Smith had a pair in the game this evening. Marty St. Louis gets his second. He continues to be hot here in Montreal. Canada wins it 5-1. Here's more from Pat Quinn on the injury to Wade Redden.
Well, that's unfortunately sports. And if you had your druthers, you wouldn't want it. I mean, we lost two big ones before the event even started. So, but, you know, it means Bollmeister would come in now, and he had a good camp for us. He's a growing and learning player, and he's going to have to step in and do a good job for us. That's just what it means. We can't change what's happened. We just have to share the responsibility and still live up to the expectations we have. Our expectations are not changing because we've lost a couple of players.
Last question in the back.
Canada, Russia, Saturday in Toronto. When we come back, we'll recap this afternoon's game between the Czechs and the Swedes and check in with Don Whitman and Greg Millen. That's next on our World Cup coverage.
A new stick for Matthew Ranzoni, $22. New pads for Jeffrey Garbick, $92. A new mouth guard for Josh Burkholder, $15. A new hockey season for the Scoville Clippers, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard, hockey fan and sponsor of the World Cup of Hockey.
Stop it!
Help me!
Oh my!
Anacondas.
Where are they?
Everywhere. Now playing in theaters everywhere.
Everything's okay?
Yeah. Studying hard, I'm sure.
Of course.
So you don't need anything?
No.
You're sure?
Mom?
Yeah?
I really miss you.
I really miss you too.
CIBC Online Banking makes it easy to take care of the things that matter.
That's my mom.
It's back and it's big. The 2004 Princess Margaret Hospital Foundation Colossal Cash and Cars Lottery. Watch your mailbox for this brochure. 10, yes, 10 grand prizes. Plus millions in cash prizes and 70 spectacular vehicles. Over 28,000 prizes, and your chances of winning are an incredible 1 in 12. Princess Margaret Hospital Foundation Colossal Cash and Cars Lottery. Watch for it.
It's been a great year, and I'd like to thank our routers and switches.
Why the success?
Bits. Low bit error rate, bit stuffing capability.
I think we sold it.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta thank the data packets.
Oh, and those little boxes that beep.
Nice job on the report.
I couldn't have done it without the patch cords, the loopback address,
the contrasting color coding of all our conductor wire.
What about the coaxial cable?
Back in Montreal, here's the North American side of the ledger. In the playoffs, first will play fourth, second will meet third. Canada, they only had to beat the Americans to have the right to play at Air Canada Centre. And with the win tonight, they have done that. The 4 points, you do get a point for an overtime defeat. But Canada cannot fall out of at least a lead on the United States, because the first criteria in the tiebreakers is head-to-head competition, and Canada has a win. So even if Russia wins a pair, including the game Saturday night, Canada will have home ice in the quarterfinals. On the European side of the ledger, Sweden is 2-0, but just got through today's game. Finland will play tomorrow in Cologne, and we'll have that game for you as part of our doubleheader. The Czechs are out of the gate poorly, but had a great third period today without Milan Hayduk in the lineup, so they might start to show something as we go along. Here are the highlights of today's game. A big line for Team Sweden is Modin, Alfredsson, and Sundin. And here's a great pass, typical Sundin. It's actually a bit of a lucky goal, but hard work paved the way for 1-0 at that point. And Henrik Zetterberg here will score to make it 4-0 in the second period. The Swedes look to have this game signed, sealed, and delivered. But a big rally by the Czechs in the third. This is a gorgeous goal by Marek Zidlicky. You see Michael Tellqvist in net wearing number 32, and that never works for a goalie, that number. Here again, Patrick Eliash. That's Kelly Rudy's number, of course. Eliash, however, here's the big save for a number 32. That's a game saver on the power play. The Czechs can't quite find the equalizer. So Sweden dodges the bullet. Boris Salming's mask inspires Tellqvist and the Swedes to a 4-3 victory. At the Globe Arena with a report, Don Whitman and Greg Millen.
Well, the Swedes continued their perfect record on home ice in World Cup play, but they had to sweat out some anxious moments in the third period before prevailing 4-3 over the Czech Republic.
Well, two different hockey games, really. The first two periods was all Sweden. Due to their special teams with three power play goals, and one thing has become very clear, you cannot get into penalty trouble against the Swedish national team. Their power play is magnificent. But then, all of a sudden, in the third period, Don, for some unknown reason, the Czech Republic decided to play hockey, something we've been waiting for them to do throughout the early stages of this tournament. It'll be interesting to see how they continue on, but they did have a great third period, made a game of it, made a one-goal game of it, but failed to tie the game up only because of Tellqvist's fantastic work in the dying minutes.
18-2, the shots on goal in the third period, favoring the Czech Republic. So they now head home, two losses, and they'll face Germany on Friday night. The Germans are in action tomorrow night as they take on Finland.
It should be a good game. I mean, the German team are always enthusiastic. They're always try hard, and the Finnish national team have had a few days rest, which they'll be rested, but will they be rusty after having an excellent game in game one against the Czech Republic? So that sets up a pretty good night, I think, tomorrow night.
Team Sweden off to a great start, two straight wins, 5-2 over Germany, and hanging on for a 4-3 win over the Czech Republic.
Thank you, gents. Brian, what do you think about today?
Well, if I'm the general manager of Team Sweden, I'm saying the rosary right now and trying to figure out my goaltending. I don't think they got what they wanted from the starter, from Salo, and I don't think they got what they wanted today. A couple preventable goals, and I think that's a problem for their team.
Yeah, Salo's done, and I think they know it, and so might as well go with Tellqvist. I like the fact that he gave up three goals and then was able to hang on, because he's going to be challenged again in this tournament, and he did it the tough way.
Does feel a bit to me like an Achilles heel, too. I'm with you. And Naslund and Forsberg used to be Modo's whole picture, but they don't seem to be clicking just yet, Brian.
Not just yet. Nazzy missed an easy chance today that he wouldn't normally miss, but I think the rest of their team is trouble, but the goaltending is a big problem.
You see our lineup tomorrow, first from Cologne, Germany, and then from St. Paul. By the way, nothing further on Mike Modena. We've heard so many different reports. He got hit in the neck by a puck, that he had some kind of a limp. But we'll give you more developments on that tomorrow. And you saw Canada plays Russia Saturday's next up for them. Up next, Brian Stewart in the National for some, Canada now for the rest. Tonight's final score, Canada 5 and Slovakia 1 for all of us here at the Bell Centre. Thanks for watching tonight, and good night.
CBC Sports, Canada's Olympic Network.
When major events...